This is your friend.
Beats the hell out of number two.
Ladies and gentlemen,
we are laughing.
Ladies and gentlemen, are you ready? Are you ready?
Get ready, y'all.
Get ready. Hey, you up yet? You're hanging out in Johnny's house.
XL 1067.
Good morning, good morning, good morning. It's 601, Orlando's number one hit music station. It's XL 1067. It's Johnny's house. It is a weather day today.
What?
Weather day today. It's going to be mostly cloudy, showers, scattered thunderstorms, heat index of 92, gusty winds up to 26 miles an hour, a chance of rain 100%.
My God, it's coming right for us.
That's right, y'all. That's right. Right now, 68.
Now, the Johnny's House Entertainment News with Ray.
So the Buzz Lightyear movie is on its way out. It's coming out on June 17th. Now, this is called Lightyear, okay. And this is not with Tim Allen.
Mm-hmm.
Tim Allen is the one that played Buzz Lightyear before, but this is with Chris Evans as the voice of Buzz.
Okay. So it's still animated, though, right?
No.
Oh, it's not animated?
From what this says.
Live action?
That's okay. So from what this says, it says that it will not be... Okay, so no, it is going to be animated.
Okay,
it's going to be the toy form that you think.
Okay.
Yeah,
so
it looks different.
You think that he is a toy,
yeah.
But it's about the Buzz Lightyear person that the toy is made
out.
Out.
Okay,
yeah,
gotcha,
okay.
Gotcha. It does make sense.
So it is animated.
Yeah.
I saw the graphic, but it doesn't look like regular animation. It looks really weird.
Yeah,
it's about the Buzz Lightyear guy that the toy was made after. So it was like, okay, it's about him and who he is as a younger person as Buzz Lightyear.
Gonna give Woody his own movie?
I don't know.
His own origin story.
I don't know
because the movie basically is gonna focus on Buzz and his original story, and people, you know, are kind of wondering why Tim Allen isn't the one to be doing this. But if you look at it, it's about Buzz Lightyear,
the real person,
before he was a toy.
Yeah,
so
yeah.
I mean, Chris probably just plays a younger version of the character.
Yeah.
So they went with a younger voice, but Chris Evans is so excited about it. He was just talking about like he's never had this like feeling before for having a part. He's got goosebumps all over the place. He has so much joy and gratitude knowing that he's a part of this original story. So
isn't he Captain America?
Yes.
Yeah. I think so. Yeah.
So Captain America is Buzz Lightyear?
Same thing.
It's going to mess with my head a little bit.
That's just so weird. I know it's just a voice, but still, like, Toy Story is such an iconic movie with four different installments. I can't picture it being anybody but Tim Allen.
They're probably doing it so they can make sure that there's a difference between
and that's what they wanted. That's what they keep saying.
Right, because Tim Allen's the toy.
The toy.
Yes.
And this is the real guy.
Yeah.
This is the dude. This is the Buzz Lightyear.
Yeah. Like, if they make a Johnny Magic toy, I could be the voice.
Yeah.
But I can't be the Johnny Magic voice.
That's right.
That's Johnny.
But people are like kind of upset, obviously, that it's not Tim Allen.
That confused the heck. If you're looking at the camera, that confused the heck out of Detroit. You're like, what?
I feel like I need to draw a diagram for her or something.
Technically speaking, Tim Allen's voice is an actor playing Buzz Lightyear.
Right.
Because Buzz Lightyear is a real person, which is Chris Evans.
Okay.
Yes.
So was like Buzz Lightyear a real person and then he turned into a toy?
Yes!
No, he didn't turn into a toy.
They made a toy after him.
Yeah.
Like G.I. Joe.
Okay.
G.I. Joe's a real person, and then they made the G.I. Joe toys
after
G.I. Joe.
Okay. And it makes more sense to me now.
Okay, there you go.
There you go.
But people obviously want to speculate and say that the reason why Tim Allen isn't like in this franchise or this part of the franchise is because it's a political thing. And I'm like, come on. He's very political. They're on the like the opposite sides of the political standpoint.
Everyone knows Buzz Lightyear is a liberal.
Yeah.
Oh my God.
I'm just kidding.
Oh my God.
He's probably an independent. I don't know.
Anyways, Warner Brothers is allegedly working on a video game. So if you're into video games, Detroit was probably going to like this. Super Smash Brothers is going to be kind of like what it is, but it's going to be called Multiverses.
What is Super Smash Brothers?
That's where you like pick your character. You're usually on some little platform and you have to knock each other off. Basically, that like sums it up, right?
It's like
Mario, basically.
Right?
Yeah, it's like Mario World. Characters.
Now,
but you also have like Link and like Jigglypuff and people like that.
And so like with Warner Brothers and their version of it, it's going to be like their characters that they're allowed to have. So like Shaggy from Scooby-Doo, the Lord of the Rings people, Batman. So it's like the Warner Brothers characters that they're allowed to have.
Okay.
Basically a version of Smash Brothers. It's going to be theirs.
Okay.
I'm not good at Super Smash Brothers.
Anything that requires
you to like memorize moves, I don't know. I just hit like every button and hope that I win.
Yeah. if the game don't involve cars driving around and shooting randomly at things.
Yeah. It's a little difficult.
Did you ever play Crazy Taxi?
I've heard of it.
Johnny would have loved it.
Yeah, you would love Crazy Taxi.
You could like pick up strippers or whatever.
It was very Grand Theft Auto.
Hold up.
Or like run them over.
So I would like this game so I can pick up hookers
now,
and
now,
run them over.
Is it strippers? I feel like there was never
they're
really
like,
strippers.
They're
there
like
was
hookers.
Like cheerleaders.
No,
there was
the
kind of crazy
prostitute.
Taxi you were playing.
No.
Was I was playing like the PG version? Are there two
I
different
swear,
versions?
There was like little prostitutes. Not like little.
That's Grand Theft Auto you're thinking.
Ray got some codes. She got the codes.
Yeah,
you
what kind
have.
Of cheat codes are you using?
Maybe it was like Crazy Taxi Extreme, but I remember my neighbor.
It was the craziest taxi.
Doug had it. His name was Doug, my neighbor.
All right,
it.
I got to find this thing. I'll tell you what.
I'll
it's 606.
It
that's trashy
we'll
taxi.
I'm like, I got hookers and picking them up. Let me see this.
That's
anyway.
GTA. You could do that in GTA.
Yeah.
You could pick up a hooker and then run her over and get your money back.
Yeah, because Crazy Taxi, you couldn't run people over. You could come close
you know,
to it,
but
they but always
scream
ran out of the
and,
way
like,
at the last
okay,
minute.
But that was
yeah.
basically to me like running them over.
Okay.
But they would scream and like run out of the way.
Yeah.
I'm going to look this up. We'll continue this discussion. 606 is Johnny's house. Six ten is Johnny's house.
It's going to be a rainy day today with highs around 84. Right now it is 68.
I think you're underselling the day. I do. It's bigger than a rainy day today.
Oh,
it is a weather
day
today.
It's going to be a stormy day.
There's a storm. I watched the news yesterday. There's a storm coming from Texas, and it's coming this way.
It's going to be aggressive.
And thank you, Ray. Very aggressive. They said it's going to hit us between 10 and 4. That's when you need to be indoors. and under the covers and stuff.
Yeah. I watched the radar, and it's not looking like it's going to be that bad at 10, at least. As far as I could see, maybe like 12.
What radar? We ain't got no radar.
I'm looking at that wall.
I was looking at the Weather Channel radar on my phone.
I don't see your documentation hanging up where you went to any sort of meteorological school.
I'm
just
going by
saying
what
I saw.
Look on TV right now. Look at all that wind. That's the wind that's coming our way.
I saw a major news story that
looks
tree,
like that was actually in Texas.
A tree fell.
That's right.
That's the
one.
Same storm
that's
coming
here. It is.
I'll believe it when I see it.
A tree fell through a house in Texas, and it's on the news in Florida. That's how big it is. Look, Jamie King don't lie on Fox 35. Look at him. He's serious.
Yeah.
This is the bomb cyclone, baby. That's what it's called, the bomb cyclone. It's coming our way.
Thunder truck's on his way out right now, I'm betting.
Bomb cyclone. I'm not joking. My kid told me that.
I did take my umbrella off my back patio, and yes. I did take down my little ghosty inflatable because I don't want him flying across the
Isn't
neighborhood.
Isn't that a song?
What's that?
She moves her body like a cyclone.
Bomb cyclone.
Do okay. All night long.
I hope it's all jokes like this tomorrow. Just saying. Anyway, looking up these video games. Crazy taxi. Now, Ray, were you confused with the...
I think I was. Yeah, now that I'm looking at it, I'm like, okay, I know for a fact that I tried to run over these little bitches that were standing on the corner.
Excuse me. That was Grand Theft.
Well, you can drive crazy in Crazy Taxi. That's the whole idea of it. But
so maybe my memory is just...
GTA is where you run people down.
The one now, you go up in a strip club. You roll up in there, they let you in. Hey, Bob. All right. You go down and the kids playing these games. My kid told me about it. He said, I've never done this, Dad, but the kids told me that they're on certain streets, they have strip clubs.
You can shoot them up.
Go up there.
But, like, do the girls, like, actually dance in there?
Yes!
Graphics and video games, too, are getting, like, too realistic. Like, when I used to play Grand Theft Auto, I played Vice City.
Vice City. So,
it was, like, decent graphics, but it wasn't, like super, super clear.
Oh, now it's you got somebody straight up running when they're running. Yeah. I messed up Vice City because someone gave me all the cheat codes. So I just put all of them in there. So I had unlimited supplies. So at that point, as soon as I hit the street, everybody in the world's after me.
I tell you guys all the time, I still remember the all weapons sheet because I used it so much. L1, R2, these are like tongue twisters for me. It's L1, L2, R1, R2, left, down, right, up, left, down, right, up. And, oh my gosh. Looks like a movie.
I'm showing Detroit the stripper scene from GTA.
Oh my gosh. At least they're still in like bra and panties. I was expecting like full movies out.
Yeah, me too.
Oh, hang on, see.
Oh, okay. Oh, wow. Oh my gosh, that is provocative. Oh my gosh.
Cartoon boobies.
I gotta see this.
Oh my gosh, you can straight up see like she's topless. Oh my gosh, this is insane. This is so vulgar.
That's the game that I have.
Yeah.
That's a video.
Is your son playing this game?
This is GTA 5.
No, he's not playing. I took it from him.
Oh my gosh, this is like watching porn.
I took it, but he told me about the strip club. So the other kids in school told me, and I, you know, me being the parent that I am, I had to drive around town till I found it.
Hey, if you push this button, you can flirt.
Oh my gosh! Wow, this has definitely changed since I used to play.
Look at Ray's face on the camera. I wish I could turn the camera so y'all could see this, but I can't because that's the porno.
Oh my gosh, this is banana land.
When he told me about it, being the parent that I am, I had to drive around. I had to go all over the city looking for that place.
Oh, but there's two girls now.
Oh my gosh,
I can't.
Oh my gosh.
Ain't nothing but a table dance. All right, first call of the day.
I cannot believe this is a video game.
Yes!
Oh, my gosh,
that's not okay.
They tell you.
She's like motorboating the other one. What is this?
It has the rating on it. It tells you.
It's GTA.
Yeah, it's not for kids.
Oh, wow.
It's not for kids.
I could probably twist the camera around and show that.
Because a lot of parents don't know that that's in there. A lot of parents do not know.
Think
about it. You guys don't know. Yeah.
If your kid is playing Grand Theft Auto, they saw their first pair of cartoon hoobies and they look like real ones.
Yep.
Wow. Right,
first call of the day, time for us to call. You know what? We ain't going to have time to talk to y'all. I ain't going to lie to you.
Sorry. I didn't mean to do that. I didn't know it was going to go that far in this.
I thought one stripper was bad. They bring in a second stripper. Dang.
Making it rain.
I'm going to twist the camera around some way. I paused it at a clean version spot.
So if you're watching us on the live stream, we'll give you a little sample of what we're watching.
And you can see what the girls are freaking out about.
We'll update you on what we did yesterday. We'll do that next on Johnny's House.
Yeah, that weather was wrong. Sorry, people on the stream can hear me, but nobody else can. But that weather was not right. Let's see. Mostly cloudy today with showers and thattered thunderstorms. Ooh, my mic. Sorry, stream people, you get the real inside stuff. Mostly cloudy with showers and scattered thunderstorms possible today. High around 84. Heat index close to 90. 100% chance of rain.
Six 23, Orlando's number one hit music station is Johnny's house.
It's going to be an extreme weather day today with highs around 84. Right now it is 68.
I dare you to keep that energy up until 9 o'clock.
Yeah,
I
dare,
no
ready?
Way. A lot better.
Cool.
It's happening, y'all.
No, because then you're going to get hate tweets on how you lied about the weather.
That's all right.
Yeah.
I'll direct them right to Johnny and Brian.
Yep.
I think you need to brand it. It's a Johnny's House Extreme Weather Day.
I like that.
We got to take
it
credit
is.
For it, yeah.
We have our, well, we don't have a thunder truck or nothing like that.
And we can write thunder truck on the side of my car. I have a truck.
I know. We can.
We can call it lightning truck.
We can do this. The weather that we've heard is going to be bad. How's that?
Perfect.
All right. Let's see. What did I do yesterday? Left here. I seriously, y'all, I'm deciding if I'm going to participate in Halloween this year. I was going to go get some candy. I'm like, nah, I don't want to get no candy. I don't know. I might not participate. It'd be my first time ever.
You better hurry and get it.
Listen, if I go in and there's no candy, then, hey, guess I wasn't supposed to participate this year.
God's plan.
I don't have candy yet either, so really? Hopefully I can still find some.
I got it on BOGO
because I kind of want some for myself.
No, well, they say the best time to buy candy, of course, is the day after Halloween. I don't think there'll be any.
Popular Mechanics has a formula for you to figure out how much candy you need.
Really?
Yeah, they have like a giant long formula times amount of kids in your neighborhood.
I don't think I could ever buy enough candy for the kids in my neighborhood.
You
really?
Yeah.
No, absolutely
Avalon's
not.
A different animal.
No.
Good.
It's
yes.
You can't.
No,
you, there's literally
not.
No way you can keep up.
Man, I had really about 3 kids come to the door. And the rest rode by in golf carts and blew their horn like I was supposed to come out.
Oh, yeah. I wouldn't participate either.
I know. 8 deep in a golf cart going, meet, 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 meet. Trick or treat. Get out of here.
If they don't walk up to me, I'm not going to give you candy.
Not my neighborhood. That's why I ain't participating.
No.
Y'all don't know the reason for the season.
Sure.
We're going to find out. When do you start the season? Over? Are you can announce that yet? Or are you going to start a new season over at the other station?
Oh, yeah, it's fine. Next Friday.
Friday.
Yeah. I'm so excited for
yes.
that.
Friday.
Yeah, me too.
I was just thinking this morning that I think I'm going to put my Christmas tree up before Thanksgiving.
Oh, people are. Oh, yeah. That used to be the thing. Not anymore.
Don't worry. Yeah. You can listen to me and put it up next Friday afternoon.
That's right. Friday afternoon.
All your holiday favorites.
They're playing Christmas over at Magic. Brad's at the station. Ray, how was yours?
It was good. I went home and relaxed and... Mm-hmm.
You had the game last night, right?
Oh, my gosh, yes. Okay, so I'm like, sorry, my brain is all fogged up.
I got you. We're in this together.
So I did have a therapy session, which was nice. It was an hour long, and I needed that, so I did that. And then we had a doubleheader yesterday for our softball games. We lost both of them, but we don't need to talk about that.
In your new jerseys?
In your new uniform.
Yes. But we lost by, like, one.
And you look good doing it.
Oh, my gosh. We looked so good yesterday. Yeah. We looked so good yesterday.
The first game, you lost by one.
I really wanted to, like, take a picture as a team, but I didn't want to be, like, that person and be like, okay, weirdo.
Yeah.
Like, you're excited about jerseys. But I really was.
Yeah.
So we lost both games.
By one?
By one, the first one, and then by three, the other one.
Yeah, it doesn't really matter because in the record book, it goes down as a loss. I'm just saying.
You should have taken the picture.
Yeah.
We did so good, though. Like, we played well. It was fun.
Oh, so you had fun even though y'all ain't win.
Yes, that's what it's about, having fun.
And winning.
Well, I mean, it is about having fun, but.
Listen, we played, and I always bring this up, we played in the same type of league you did, but flag football. We lost every week. It was no fun. We lost every
week.
Well,
because you guys got pounded every week.
Yeah, we did.
We're actually putting up good games here.
Hey, we had jerseys from the very beginning,
yes,
though.
Yes, we had nice jerseys.
That's cool, because did you have a container floating out there in the ocean for 5 months
with our jerseys on it?
No. You know why? Because we got our jerseys local.
Yeah.
A local company made them for us.
Touche.
How was yours, man?
It was good. It was good. I picked the kid up from football, and it was nice out. So instead of bothering him with making dinner, we went and had dinner.
Went outside?
Yeah, we went to Bahama Breeze. We haven't been there in a while.
Yeah.
And ate on the patio. It was very nice.
What'd you have?
They have coconut shrimp tacos now.
Ooh.
What?
They're new on the menu. They're delicious.
What?
Yeah. So we actually, all three of us ordered that because it was they look so good. So we had that. Shout out to Angela. She's the manager there. She's a big listener.
What's up, Angela?
So she says hello. So we ate outside because it was just nice out, and then it was Survivor date night.
Mm-hmm.
They're really messing up Survivor this year. I don't like it. There's just too many moving parts and crazy advantages and sneaky this and sneaky that. I'm like, just go play the game.
You think it's their way because, you know, every time you know, you get some consultants in, you got to change it up.
Got to revamp.
But I'm like,
you're in season 41. People like the base of the game.
Yeah.
Making it more like reality TV?
I feel like it totally is. Like, they're like, they got to, like, drum up the drama, and it seems like they're starting to typecast like the way Real World did after a while.
Oh, really?
And so I'm like, that's not cool. Like, that's not what people love. So maybe the ratings will reflect that. And I want it to be old school like it was first couple seasons.
Yeah.
You throw, like, one immunity idol out there, and you figure it out.
Yeah.
Now they got if this, then this, and you can steal someone's this, and it's like, it's just too much.
Yeah.
Dang.
It's too much.
Detroit, how about you?
It was good. I got home yesterday. I had a little doctor's appointment. That was fun.
You and the baby are good?
Good. It was good. Yeah. I had to get more blood drawn, which this time it was only one tube instead of 1,700. But this lady was aggressive. Oh, my gosh. It hurt so bad when she shoved the needle in my arm. Usually it doesn't hurt. Like, you feel like a little bit of a pinch, but it doesn't hurt. This hurt the whole time it was in my arm. So I was like, thank God it's only one tube because I could not sit here for all the tubes I had to get last time.
Really?
And then it hurt like the whole way home, and it still kind of hurts.
There are some people who are good at drawing blood.
Yeah.
There's some that.
Oh, she was not one of them. She was aggressive, and it hurt so bad. But we picked up pizza on the way home. We tried a new pizza place by our house, and it was really, really good.
Your husband ate pizza?
He ate pizza.
Yes! What happened to the beef cheeks and liver?
He had a cheat day. I don't know if he's going to keep
cheat days are good.
Keep it up. Yeah. But his problem is, like, I told him, I was like, listen, we're going to get pizza, but you don't have to eat the whole thing. Mm-hmm. And then your stomach hurts. And then you say, oh, we can't eat pizza anymore.
Yeah, you can't eat the whole
thing. And that's exactly what happened. He ate the whole thing. I didn't even eat half of mine. Like, it was a big pizza.
But you know why? Because his taste buds are like, he's back.
Right.
Yeah. He is back. Yeah.
It was like fireworks in his mouth.
Yeah, literally it was. So we did that. And then we just caught up on some TV shows. And that was really it.
Very good. Very good. Listen, we come back. You know, Brian does not believe in ghosts. And we're going to talk to you. If you didn't believe him, believe in ghosts. And then something happened. And now you believe. We're going to talk about that next on Johnny's House. It is Thursday morning, 6:38. This is Johnny's house.
It's going to be an extreme weather day today with highs around 84, 100% chance of rain right now, 68.
It is going to be.
My God, it's coming right for us.
Okay, you made your point. You can stop. It's just going to be careful with the weather today. Who knows what's going to happen?
It's going to rain.
It's going to rain.
And you guys can't barely drive when it's dry.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, my gosh. I said rainy day. You guys said it wasn't enough.
No, you said,
and now it's too much.
No,
what do you want from
said,
me?
You said, it's going to rain today. And then you went to, it's going to rain. Oh, my God. Just somewhere, you know, just a little random. Anyway, be careful. It's going to be a weather day today. Now, Brian, you do not believe in ghosts.
No, I just don't. I've seen nothing that would make me think that there is any sort of supernatural anything.
Ray, you believe in ghosts.
Yes, I believe in spirits.
In spirits, okay.
Not ghosts.
Well, please tell me the difference.
Yeah, I guess ghosts kind of have like a negative kind of connotation
to
them.
So I believe that there's like some people's souls that are still like
here,
lingering
on the
around.
Earthly plane.
Yes.
I think when you think ghosts, you got to remove the person wearing a sheet looking like Casper.
Oh, no.
Yeah.
Like, obviously, that doesn't exist.
And Detroit, what about you?
I mean, I believe kind of like how Ray does in spirits. Like, I don't think all spirits are visible, you know? Like, some people will see things, but I don't think you necessarily have to see something for something to be there.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And Brian, you...
Absolutely not. There's literally...
No fear of it, no nothing,
no nothing. No, because I can't be afraid of something that I don't believe exists, so that's not possible. I mean, you could be kind of creeped out, like, just by the idea of it because your body gets anxiety from, like, when we went to that haunted house.
Yeah.
Like, you go up to that room upstairs. They tell you all the stories. It's pitch black. So, I think your anxiety level raises. But then after you sit there for a minute and you see literally nothing happen, it's very hard for me to go, oh, okay, yeah, it's haunted, like, because I just don't believe it. I've lost a ton of people that were close to me.
Yeah.
None of them have ever reached out to me. I've never seen anything that I thought to myself, ooh, that was... supernatural. Wow. So there's just nothing that I'm thinking logically. There's nothing that I've seen that made me go, okay.
I told you, I think, and I mentioned this when we were kids years ago, a good friend of ours lost his mom. She had something happen when she died in the bathtub. And we were outside of his house playing like maybe a month or so later, and it's around 11 o'clock. And I'll never forget it. We're hanging under the streetlight, and he had a big tree in his front yard. And we look over, and we see this figure. The head on a white dress blowing in the wind. There was no wind. And he went over and talked to her.
Why is it always a woman in a white dress?
Yeah, I don't get that.
There's always a woman in a white dress, and it freaks me out.
I wish I could say it was a flower print, paisley, but no. And we all saw it, and we all ran home. And to this day, I'm telling you, and I said this last time, I could probably call one of my friends I hadn't talked to in maybe 30, 40 years and say, hey, you remember when we saw Robbie's mom? He's like, oh, yeah, she's coming out from the tree that night. Yeah, she was talking to Robbie. And we asked him, like, what did she say to you? And he's like, well, she said everything's okay, don't worry. And at that point, I'm like, okay.
See, I can't discount your story. I wasn't there.
Yeah.
I can't tell you what you saw, what
exactly,
you didn't see.
Exactly.
So I would never try to do that.
Yeah.
I've never seen anything that makes me go, oh, okay, there's a ghost. So until that happens to me. There's nothing that anyone can say to make me think it's true or real.
We were kids. And I was sitting there going. And the next day we all got back together. What'd you see last night? What'd you see? And it was like everybody saw the same thing.
I feel like there's things that have happened to me where I like probably should have been hurt or like injured. And I feel like somebody was like watching over me. Like I feel like there was like, you know, like my grandpa was like saved me from what just happened.
In my life, I call it divine intervention. That means something happened that you're like, wait a minute.
Yeah.
That was weird.
That's why I'm like, okay, something should have just happened and nothing happened.
I've had a few of those, but I mean, I don't believe it's because anything saved me.
Maybe
I got lucky. Final destination type stuff. My time wasn't up.
Yeah.
Maybe ghosts are kind of like Santa Claus. Like those who don't believe don't receive.
Yeah, but Johnny didn't believe or not believe until he saw it.
We were kids.
He was a kid.
Like,
Well, yeah, but he didn't not believe.
Yeah.
Right, but he didn't also believe. He was just being. It just happened to be out that day.
And we were all
maybe
out there
by like strictly not believing, you're not welcoming them in. You don't feel welcome in your life.
I don't believe now because of not have seen anything before. I didn't grow up with a strong disbelief of ghosts, so they never showed up.
Okay, fair enough.
I want to talk to you. If you were a non-believer in ghosts or the supernatural, and now you believe, what happened that now you do believe? Before you were like, Brian, like, you know what? I haven't seen anything. I mean, hey, other people can do it. Other people seen it. That's fine. But for me in my life, I haven't. But for you, what happened? And then you're like, nah, I don't believe. Uh-oh, I believe now. We want to hear your story. 407-919-1067, 877-919-1067. You can text the XL Mobile is 41067. You can tell your story on social media. And if you're watching this right now on the live stream, yes, we are up and we are live. And let me tell you, they have a little community in there.
I know.
They become friends and talk
to
each other.
That.
You can drop a comment there. All right. You didn't believe in ghosts? Now you do. What happened? Share it with us right here on Johnny's House. 653 is Johnny's house.
Mostly cloudy today with a 100% chance of thunderstorms. Right now it is 70.
Very good. I like that. Cool. It's good right there.
Nice Brian in the middle.
Dramatic, you know, music in the background. Listen, Brian does not believe in ghosts.
No.
And you were like that. You were like, Brian, you did not believe until something happened, and now you believe in ghosts or the supernatural or spirits or the thereafter, and the list can go on and on. We want to hear why. What changed you? Mortician Bobbert. What's up, Mortician Bobbert? All right. Good morning to you, Mortician Bobbert. So you were like Brian. You didn't believe what happened, and all of a sudden now you believe. Wow. Just like that. Wow. Wow. Yes.
With the white dress,
yes.
Right?
Yes. Robbie's
okay,
mom.
Okay, Brian, I know you are Mr. Research, so you can research this, fact check me. But that is an urban legend in America. It's called The Woman in White. She kills herself after finding out her husband cheated on her.
That could have happened.
Yeah.
That could have happened because it was mysterious. It was mysterious the way she died.
Yeah. So, Johnny, it's actually supposed to be extremely bad luck to see that. So you must be blessed somehow because...
Well, I know I'm blessed. I know that.
Yeah.
I know. I know this. And by the way, man, I just want to say, if your wife is a hospice nurse, she's an angel.
Yeah, really.
She really is an angel.
That's a tough job.
It is. And there's hospice nurses that are amazing at it. So, you know, hats off to her. All right, Mortician.
Thank you.
Mortician Bobbert, you have a beautiful day.
You too. Thanks, guys. Uh-huh.
Yeah, that's the same story literally around the world.
Is it?
I'm looking at it in every country.
Really?
It's the same story.
Huh.
All right. Man. Jamie, good morning.
Morning, Johnny.
How you
and
doing?
Brian and Sandra Ray and all you guys. How are you guys doing today?
You only missed one other person. It was not all
that's
of
okay.
us. You said Detroit.
That's cool.
And then you got us all up
I almost
there.
Forgot her. Hey, Detroit. Yeah,
you
almost forgot.
You said everybody cool. else, but you left her out.
Yeah,
she has feelings.
Right.
All right,
I feel you.
I'm messing with you, bro. All right, so what happened, man?
I used to not believe in angels until one night in May of last year. I was up late. I couldn't sleep. It's like this inner voice said, Jamie, do not go to sleep or something bad is going to happen to you. Lo and behold, about 1:15 in the morning, I hear a loud, like a bomb went off, basically. Come to find out, a truck had blasted right through one of the walls of my bedroom.
Woo!
Where my bookshelf had once been. What saved my life was some kind of way my bed shifted 6 inches, about 6 inches. Had that bed not moved, I wouldn't be here today. And when the police officer came out to check and see what happened, try to catch the person responsible, I asked the officer, I said, ma'am, I don't know if you believe in angels, but there had to have been an angel watching me that night. Because it took a while. I had to stay at a friend's house because my bedroom was pretty beat up.
Yeah,
and they had to rebuild everything and paint everything and pretty much put my life back together.
Jamie, when did you realize that the bed had moved over? Was it after the accident, or when did you find out?
Well, because I'm visually impaired, my mom actually, because I live here with family,
mm-hmm.
so because I'm visually impaired, my mom's like, Jamie, your bed moved 6 inches. I said, what? And she said, yeah. She said, that saved your life. And I'm like, and the crazy thing was, I didn't even realize what had happened until I could feel like pieces of, the sheetrock that walls are, some walls are made from.
Yeah, yeah.
I could feel like pieces of the sheetrock were just raining down on me. And I said, oh my Lord. Okay, God.
I can tell you're excited now. I can hear it now. Now,
yeah.
Nobody in the world might believe you, Jamie, but you believe you. I know this.
Yeah, listen. If there's an angel up there, he must be working overtime at 1:00 a.m. because And it took some doing, you know, it took some work had to be done. But eventually my bedroom was eventually restored to what it was before.
I tell you, man, I tell you. Kind of scary. Read what they say over there. Non-believers, non-believers.
A couple of people are with Brian saying they don't believe it whatsoever, but somebody said ghosts are real. Be happy you don't have personal experiences with them to believe in them. Christina also says, I've seen them with my own eyes. The first time was my great-grandmother when I was around 7 years old. I've also gone on excursions to seek out apparitions. Mm-hmm. And spirits, and they are very, very real and very alive.
You need to post that ghost photo your mom has.
I don't know what, happened to it. Yeah.
All right. What did they say over there?
XL Mobile powered by attorney Dan Newland in a rec need a check. Call Dan Newland. Someone said they are more emotionally attached to things and people. They're afraid to let go.
Yeah, yeah.
And they said it's usually women because they say spirits are stuck because there's undone work and women are nurturing. So they feel like their job is never done.
Okay. Okay. Hmm. All right. Oh, let's move on. Ms. Ray, what you working on?
Some more stuff with Wendy Williams has come out.
Okay, I want to hear this. Coming up, Johnny's House.
XL 1067 has your chance at $1,000 and a VIP trip to our iHeartRadio Jingle Ball. Now, text the nationwide keyword SHOW, S-H-O-W, to 200-200. You'll get a confirmation text and info. Standard data and message rates apply in this nationwide contest. That's SHOW to 200-200. Good luck.
What's up? This is Billie Eilish.
What's up, everybody? This is Justin Bieber.
This is Dua Lipa.
Now, the Johnny's House Entertainment News with Ray.
Florida's home for fun, sexy style. Visit Venus.com. So, Wendy Williams, if you haven't seen the announcement, her ex-husband is engaged.
He's cold. That's a cold brother.
Kevin
right there.
Hunter.
He's cold. He is cold.
And his one-time mistress is what they're saying, Sharina Hudson.
She's a side piece for years.
Yeah, and she's the one that actually has the love child with him. Mm-hmm. So, so what they're saying is that he is engaged. We don't know exactly the timeline. Yes, but they're saying that that ring is valued around $80,000. But he popped the question sometime last year, they're saying, and she appeared on Instagram with, like, you know, a massive ring on her finger, and some people like finally got the report mm-hmm. that they are engaged. And this comes after she was admitted, Wendy Williams was admitted to a New York City hospital for psychiatric evaluation. So a lot of people are just saying that this is just
the
like,
time is just not good.
It's just, yeah. So we don't know if she found out about the engagement and then kind of just, you know, there's just so many things when you question like a timeline, especially when it comes to somebody's like mental health like that. But she said, people are saying that right there is probably the cause of her recent health issues. Mm. And just like when you're fighting Graves' disease and all that stuff, it's like, you know, your immune system and all that is just like, it's questionable.
The hurting thing is that it's her money to pay for that ring.
Yes. Yep. Yeah.
So paid for everything in his life.
Yeah.
Yeah. So basically what they're saying is that it's kind of terrible that he's just living off her money while she's just like in a hospital, you know, fighting for her mental stability. And people are saying this is not good whatsoever. So a lot of her fans and everything are coming out wishing her well, because obviously this is going to be a very big struggle for her.
Dang.
Yeah. So if you see Pray for Wendy floating around, that's why. Did you see? Okay. I was not excited for Tiger King 2. But did you see the trailer?
I saw the trailer.
Okay. So the trailer came out.
You see it?
I did not.
I've not seen the original Tiger King.
Okay.
So it looks like Joe Exotic is going to be making some appearances in Tiger King 2. We thought that he wasn't going to be like in it whatsoever.
With his worst haircut yet.
Yo.
Oh, he is mad.
Did you see his bangs?
Oh, yes.
His little bangs and his mullet. I love it. So, yeah, they released the trailer for season 2, and it appears to have as much drama, if not more, as the first season that we watched through the beginning of the pandemic. So, I mean, if you see it, he like makes a phone call from prison, and he talks about how all these people that were in Tiger King 1, they're so rich and wealthy, it changed our lives.
What's my boy you don't like who wears the Ed Hardy?
Is it Jeff Lowe.
Carol Baskin's first husband.
No. This is the guy who had the young wife, and he has the...
Yeah.
Okay. He comes out and goes, I have more money than God.
Yes.
He said
I hate him.
Yeah, so like all the people, Jeff Lowe, Alan Glover,
they're
like all
balling.
These people, they are so rich right now off of Tiger King while he rots in prison.
So rich that he's still rocking Ed Hardy.
Yeah. So basically in the trailer, it says that there's an innocent man in prison and all that stuff.
He's mad.
It's going to be 5 episodes coming out on November 17th. So we're just a couple of weeks away from that.
Now, I'm not telling you anything that's not in the trailer.
No.
He said this. He said, if I could cut a deal with the devil to get out of here, I would cut that deal.
Yes.
Well, he came close to almost cutting a deal with Carol Baskin.
All right, you've said her name 3 times now.
Yes.
3 times you've said it.
Hit it!
Carol Baskin.
What?
Killer husband
whacked him. Can't convince me
that it didn't happen. Fed him to tigers, they snacking. What's happening? Carol Baskin.
Yeah.
He said that too. It's like, and ain't nobody asking about Kim asking husband. Ain't nobody asking about that. But I'm in jail.
I'm going to post the trailer. So if you are into it, I was not excited until I saw this. They did very well on this trailer.
He's angry. And he has every right to be. He says, you got an innocent man in jail. Everybody out there is making money. Everybody.
Yeah, you see, like,
hates Carol Baskin.
Is it Jeff Lowe that's like crawling on a bed with like other
women?
And stuff?
Yes. Oh, my goodness. Oh, this is crazy. All right, it's Thursday. Let's play the throwback game next on Johnny's House. Orlando's number one hit music station is XL 106.7 709.
It's going to be a stormy day today with highs around 84. Right now it is 70.
All right, Baby DJ is right around the corner. We're actually going to start asking for submissions here in about 3 weeks or so. That's how close we are to the holidays. And we're looking for an administrative assistant. This is a paid position. It is not free. We pay you. We pay you above average. But it's only for a couple of weeks. It's from mid-November till December 23rd. It's when we wrap it up. And the last person we had, Natalie, she's an amazing. She was with us 2 years. She got a job in New York and said, hey, listen, I'll come back and do that for you guys. Like, no. I appreciate you, but you're in New York doing big things. We just have to try to see if we can find someone just as special as you. You'll be responsible for databasing, preparing call sheets, coordinating, confirming volunteers. And it takes a lot of volunteers to do Baby DJ. Updating drop-off locations, monitoring the Baby DJ phone, assistance director, Carmen. This is an important position. You have to be organized to do it. And like I say, it is a paid position. And if you have some time and you like to make some holiday cash and you got a good heart because we work, you know, and it's helping out families in need this holiday season. We're going to put links on all our social media, or you can go to babydj.org and under administrative assistant, click there, and it'll tell you exactly what you need to do and who you need to email your information to, because we're looking to hire someone in the next week or so. So if you're an administrative assistant or you're very organized and you just want to got a big heart and you want to help and get paid, just go to babydj.org and go to administrative assistance, and it'll tell you exactly what to do. If you can't, then find somebody that will, because we need to get this thing started. The building has said we can use a location, hadn't told us which one, either here or in another one, and we made some modifications. We don't know what to expect this year. People always say, so what do you expect? I don't know. I don't know. They say there's a toy shortage and there's families in need. So, but every year we seem to make it happen, and we can't do it without you. So if you're looking for a job, administrative assistant position for Baby DJ, go to babydj.org and give you the information, or go to our social media and we can find you there. Okay. All right, it is time for the throwback game. We have questions from back in the day in four different categories. We have movie premises, we have music, we have pop trivia, and we have TV. And if you win today, we're going to hook you up with a pair of tickets to see the New Kids on the Block, the mixtape tour. It's 2022, Salt and Pepper, In Vogue, Rick Astley. Never going to give you up. You got any Rick Astley?
We have his two jams, that one and there's one other.
There's
one.
No Stranger to Love. Detroit, you know who that is?
I know the Never Gonna Give You Up.
Yeah, because
Never Gonna Say Goodbye.
Because of the Rickroll thing, right? Everybody knows that.
Man.
Because of the social media thing where you put a link.
Oh,
to,
yeah. Everything to, goes to Rick Astley.
Yeah. Oh, his other win was Together Forever, which
Together
sounds
forever.
Exactly the same.
They do. And he has that dance.
He aged pretty well.
I can imagine him in concert.
I don't know what he's going to sing out after these two songs. That's what I don't know.
Good night, Orlando.
I mean, they have a bunch of bands, and New Kids have a big catalog. So.
I wish he would come out talking about. I wish he would come out saying, before I get to my hits, I want to play my new song. No!
Oh, hell no.
It'd probably sound just like this.
I know.
Any other guy. I just want to tell you how I'm feeling. Trying to make you understand.
Never gonna let you down. So I got a pair of tickets to see New Kids on the Block mixtape tour 2022. Salt and Pepper, Invo, and MacGyver there, Rick Astley, is going to be July 10th, 2022. Before you know it, it'll be here. Believe me, it's at the Amway Center. If you would like to play, 407-919-1067, 877-919-1067. When you come back, let's do it. Let's play the throwback game on Johnny's House.
Hi, I'm Chris from the band Coldplay. We're returning to America for a tour.
See their Tampa show free.
I want to get my nails done. Check. You can win tickets to come and see us play all this week.
Just head over to our Instagram at
XL1067
and tag the friend you're going to take with you.
This traffic center is brought to you by the one and only attorney Dan Newland.
This report is sponsored by SeaWorld.
Westbound I-4 is very slow from Maitland Boulevard to Princeton Street. Looks like they just wrapped up some overnight construction. Have a serious accident being investigated northbound on Avalon Park Boulevard at Golden Rain Tree Boulevard. A vehicle on its side in the right turn lane, southbound on Apopka Vineland Road at Winter Garden Vineland Road. And there's a crash in the left turn lane eastbound on US 192 at Bally Boulevard. See traffic problems? Call the SafeTouchSecurity.com traffic tip line at 866-676-8477. From the Traffic Center, I'm Daisy Ash.
Pay your bills with $1,000 at least 12 times every weekday. Plus, be the VIP at our iHeartRadio Jingle Ball in New York City. You'll see Ed Sheeran. It's true, my bad habits lead to you. Doja Cat. Baby, I need to know. Dua Lipa. Got me in love again. Lil Nas X. Jonas Brothers, Saweetie, AJR, and more.
Do you want to feel it tonight?
We'll fly you first class to New York City to be the iHeartRadio Jingle Ball VIP. Keep listening for your chance to win up to 12 times every weekday.
Jingle Ball!
Y'all ready to have some fun?
Where can you stream the CW's hottest new shows and your favorite smash hits, Superman and Lois, All American, Riverdale, and more, all for free? On the CW app. No login, no subscription, just free.
October is Guest Appreciation Month at Ideal Image Med Spa. They're celebrating by giving you up to 70% off laser hair removal. And if you're a healthcare worker, first responder, or teacher, ask for additional savings. Now, Ideal Image Med Spa is America's number one choice for laser hair removal. I've been going there for years, getting the best results. And on top of that, all of the confidence I could ever ask for. If you go to my social media, you'll see a highlight reel right there of how much I absolutely love Ideal Image Med Spa, and I want you to have that feeling as well, so you don't have to deal with the bump.
right, 720, time to play the throwback game. That's where we ask you questions in four different categories. And the person that gets the most right today, we're going to hook you up with a pair of tickets to see the New Kids on the Block, the mixtape tour 2020. 2022, it's going to be Salt-N-Pepa in Vogue, Rick Astley, July 10th. 2022 at the Amway Center. But the first thing we must do is meet our contestant, contestant number one from St. Cloud, Alexandria. Good morning.
Good morning.
All right, for the sake of the game, how old are you?
I am 39.
39. In the past, how have you done? Okay.
In my car, I've done fantastic.
Okay. And this is the day you say you're going to do it all, huh?
I sure hope so.
All right. These are all horror movies, and they can be up to date. Or back in the day, and if you listen closely, there's always a clue, okay?
Okay.
All right. A young African-American had to get out to visit his white girlfriend's parents for the weekend while his simmering uneasiness about the reception of him eventually reaches a boiling point.
Is it Get Out?
Get Out is correct. You got the point. All right. After a ship's merchant vessel receives an unknown transmission as a distress call, one of the crews is attacked by an alien life form, and they soon realize that its life cycle is merely the begun.
Alien?
Alien is correct. You got the point. Detroit, give me some music.
All right, Alexandria, these are pop hits from 1999. I need the title of the song or the artist who sings it.
Alexandria.
That's Britney Spears.
Yes, yeah. Ma'am.
Look at you playing the game. Look
Here's
at you.
Here's another. I never want to hear you say,
I want it that way. I'm an NSYNC fan, but that's Backstreet Boys.
Yes, yeah. Ma'am.
Halfway through Detroit.
Four for four.
Way to go. All right, pop trivia, please.
Okay, which 90s girl group is the second best-selling group after the Spice Girls? They had hit songs like Unpretty and Waterfalls.
TLC.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, okay.
Okay, shows like Boy Meets World, Full House, Family Matters were part of this ABC primetime lineup.
You know this.
It was on Fridays.
You know it.
Dude.
Say it.
Oh, I don't know.
I would have either taken TGIF or Thank God It's Friday.
Yes, you know it.
Yeah.
Okay.
All right, B. All right, some TV. Kelly Clarkson was the winner of season one of American Idol, who finished second and went on to make a movie with Kelly, and he's now Little Sweet on the Dr. Pepper commercials.
That is... Justin.
You feel it?
I'll take just Justin. Okay, that's okay.
That's fine.
Yeah, because okay. It's Justin Guarini, but the movie was Kelly to Justin.
I loved that movie.
Really?
Did you really?
I loved Kelly Clarkson.
Oh, she absolutely hated that she had to make that movie.
Oh, I loved that movie so much.
Let's see. How about this one? Dexter, in the original run, he ends as a lumberjack. What was his job for the rest of the first run of Dexter?
Come
on.
I know, I'm a mortician. He was a...
Well, look, Alexandra, come on now.
I know. I'm having...
It's okay. All right, we give about three more seconds. Time up.
Sorry.
He was a caterer. No, I'm just kidding. No. He was a blood spatter expert.
Yeah.
That's right.
I'm just curious. Would you have taken cop?
No.
No. Okay.
No, because it's pretty specific what he did. Yeah.
All right. Well, you hold on. Yeah, she finished with how many points?
6 points.
6 points. That's good, though. You hold on. Yeah. You never know.
All right. Thank you.
All right. Let's say, I can do better than 6 points from Ocala. Lisa. Lisa, good morning.
Good morning.
All right. For the sake of the game, how old are you?
40.
And how did you do that last round?
I got them all.
Oh!
Wow.
Well, all you need to do is get more than six, okay?
We'll see what happens.
All right, these are horror movies. A Phoenix secretary embezzles $40,000 from her employee's client. She goes on the run, checks into a remote hotel run by a psycho under the domination of his mom. Do you want to hear that again? You want to hear it again?
Yes.
Okay. A Phoenix secretary embezzles $40,000 from employees. She goes on the run, checks into a remote hotel run by a psycho under the domination of his mother.
the Bates Motel.
Psycho.
Oh. I'm really bad at horror movies.
I said it's run by a psycho.
$40,000?
No. Yeah, back then it was.
Back then that was a lot of money.
A lot of money. You don't have to go on the run for $40,000.
Nah, that's a slap on the wrist.
All right, here's another one. A young FBI cadet must receive the help from an incarcerated, manipulative cannibal killer, Hannibal Lecter, to help catch another serial killer, a madman who skins his victims.
Ugh.
Hannibal.
That's his name, Hannibal Lecter.
Silence of the Lambs.
Okay, woo!
The sequel was called Hannibal.
Yeah,
but
you got the point. Okay. We'll give it to you. All right. Let's see here. Let's go with some music.
All right, Lisa, these are pop hits from the year 1999. I need the title of the song or the artist who sings it.
Christina Aguilera.
Yup. Nice job. Here's okay. Another one.
Lisa.
Oh, my God.
Lisa.
Can I hear that again?
Can you play it again? You want to play it again?
Yeah, but only because I want to hear it again.
Lisa.
Loved You Before I Met You. I can't remember who sings that.
Oh, close, but no, it was I Know I Loved You, or I Knew I Loved You by Savage Garden.
All right, how many points?
You have 2 points.
Now, if I'm not mistaken, you have to run the table to tie.
Yes. Ooh.
Is that right?
Yes.
To tie, you have to run the table just to tie the game. Are you ready, Lisa? Okay. No pressure.
I'm ready.
All right.
Okay, artists like Britney Spears, NSYNC, and Eminem were regulars on top of this chart of this popular MTV music video show hosted by Carson Daly.
CRL.
Yeah.
All right, here we go.
All right, these wide leg jeans became a fashion staple for kids in the 90s. Their slogan was Judge None, Choose One.
Genko?
Yes.
Oh, okay. Question
nice.
If she's right. Now, here it is.
I never had a pair of those.
You get these next two right, you tie. You get one wrong, it's over. We hang up without even saying goodbye. No, we won't do that. We'll say goodbye.
That's
me. I know.
I don't know which one to give her first because I want her to get the first one.
Here we go.
All right. There were two hosts on season one of American Idol. Who was Ryan Seacrest's co-host that was not brought back after Ooh. Season one?
Ryan Dunkelman.
Yes! Girl, I was about to put money. You wouldn't know that.
Yes.
I'm glad you answered up quickly.
That big dummy.
All right, here it is.
All right.
Get this right, it's a tie. We go to the tiebreaker. You get it wrong, it's over. No pressure.
All right. Ryan. What city does the majority of the series Dexter take place in?
I like that.
Miami.
That is correct.
Oh, we have a tie. Okay. I like it. You came out strong. All right, B, if you can, connect them both.
Either.
All right. All right, did you, Alexandra, did you hear that? It is a tie.
I did.
All right, here is the question, and Alexandra, you get to go first, okay? What is, and this is a percentage, what is the number of kids who would rather get a toothbrush than candy while trick-or-treating? Alexandra, what is your answer?
I would say 30%.
30%. Okay, Lisa, what would you say?
The number of kids that would rather get a toothbrush than candy?
Yes.
Percentage.
Yes.
10%?
The answer is 0!
0%.
0%. Congratulations.
Trick question.
Yeah, trick question.
That's what I wrote. 0.
Trick question.
0. Congratulations, Lisa. You are the winner.
Oh, my God. My daughter's going to be so excited.
You got some pair of tickets. Check out the New Kids on the Block mixtape tour 2022. Salt and Pepper in Vogue. Rick Ashley is going to be July 10th, 2022 at the Amway Center. Way to play the game, Alexandria.
Thank you.
All right. Going to put you both on hold so we can get some information from you. The answer is 0.
If you didn't win, there's another chance you can register at xl1067.com. I feel bad.
I do, too. I do. It was a trick question. All right, we come back. We're going to find out why are you mad? It's a lot of reason to be mad. We're going to find out why you mad on Johnny's House. 7:39 on a Thursday. It's Johnny's house.
It's going to be some scattered thunderstorms today with highs around 84. Right now it is 71.
Got another shortage alert. We should come up with a bid. Shortage alert.
Oh, my God.
I don't know if this is going to be a shortage because I think some people now are just trying to get in and jack their prices up because they know things are kind of rough. But the wine industry.
I saw this morning.
The wine industry said that, hey, because of the supply chain bottleneck, they have a shortage of bottles. And the same thing that you're talking about with the liquor, right?
Yeah, same thing.
Listen, I'll take my wine in a plastic bag. I don't care.
That is the good thing for wine is they can put them in boxes.
Oh, yeah. Yes. Oh, yeah. Now, everywhere I've gone, there's plenty of wine. I just don't see a shortage. Maybe if you have a particular, you know, if you want that Bordeaux 19, whatever. Well, that's already bottled, though. If you wanted that old school.
Yeah, yes. The stuff that's like already really, there. Really
it's really good.
So they said there's like a perfect storm. There's some problem with some of the grape crops, obviously.
Yeah.
And then there is the shipping issue, of course.
Mm-hmm.
And then the glass shortage.
Yep.
So when you add all those things together, it's going to be the new wine.
Yeah.
The old wine.
Yeah, yeah. Yo, you get that.
But that's high dollar wine. Yeah. See? So it's for us cheap folks. That's we're going to run into the problem.
It's what he said. The NOAA has recorded California and several other Western, of course, page change. Other Western states have had the hottest summer on record, exceeding the 1936 Dust Bowl. So that has something to do with the grapes and extreme droughts and all that stuff. So if you like that new wine,
yeah,
you're in trouble.
That Reunited. But like, you're going to be able to get that.
Hey.
What is that, Lambrusco?
Yes. Do not let my family know that. They'll go out and buy all of it right now.
Sounds like y'all need to switch to rum, and I know a good local one that you could get. No problem.
So I wonder if there's going to be a shortage in like Richard's Wild Irish Rose, a Boom Farm, you know, those real cheap. That's the new stuff?
I mean, theoretically, there should be, although they probably have so much of that stuff produced and just sitting in a warehouse somewhere.
Ooh. Troy, you ever try? I always gauge everything about Troy because she's the youngest on the show. You ever have any Richard's?
No.
Boom Farm?
No.
You've never had Boone's?
The first time I had Boone's Farm was Red Hot and Boom a couple of years ago because you guys had it in your hotel room. Yeah.
Why do we have Boom Farm in our hotel?
I think Jen brought it.
It's delicious.
Oh, it's not even cheap wine.
Boone's Farm isn't cheap wine? I thought it was cheap.
It is cheap.
It's below cheap. You got cheap wine, and then you got...
It's 7-Eleven wine. Yeah. Not that there's anything wrong with 7-Eleven wine.
It's in the long bottles. It's
not around. How much is it for a bottle?
The price has never gone up.
Probably like $6. Yeah. Okay. Maybe. See, we always went for like Barefoot or Cupcake.
That's a whole different kind of wine.
That's like middle class.
That's Publix wine.
We're talking below this.
We're talking gas station wine.
Yeah, Richard.
But from what I hear, my mom used to really enjoy Boone's Farm wine.
Woo!
Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah, and Mad Dog.
Mad Dog 2020.
MD 2020.
Oh my gosh, I love
man.
Those.
There's so many flavors.
Your mom used to drink cheap wine?
Yeah, I guess in high school that was her jam.
That's how far it goes back.
Yeah. She tries to play it off like she didn't do that kind of stuff. My dad's like, you used to get hammered.
Your mom had a little street in her. I don't know if you know this or not.
I ain't saying it. I'm looking at like, your mom used to. Oh.
Yeah. Can't picture my mom with any kind of street in her, but it's pretty exciting to find out.
Your mom used to drink that Boone's Farm. Wow. Anyway, that's wine shortage.
I'm trying to see how much it is. Boone's Farm.
Can't be.
There's
no more.
Tons of
I
flavors.
I'd say $3 a bottle. Gotta be. No more than $3 to $4 a bottle. It's a Boone Farm.
That sounds like a terrible hangover.
Yes, I'm 21. It's not even to show me the price.
Oh, yeah.
Let me see. MD
Let's
20.
See if you can.
20.
I could get what are one. The Mad Dogs? Is that like a malt beverage? Like
no, well, Mad Dog.
It's also cheap wine.
You can get some Mad Dog 2020 Orange Jubilee. For $3.99.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
They got strawberry kiwi. They got every flavor you can think of.
I always went for the Four Loko because that was $2.99.
We didn't have that.
Mad Dog comes in a can now.
Does it really?
Oh, my gosh, you guys.
How much?
This starts at $4. Boone's Farm.
Yeah. It's always been $4.
$4.26. Just hearing that gives me a headache.
No, you understand. It lights your liver up. Lights it up.
Oh, I believe it.
Yeah, it's pretty bad. Anyway, let's find out, why are you mad? What is happening in your life right now has you just mad, angry? There's a lot of stuff going on. And we want you the opportunity to vent right here on the radio. Tell us why you're mad. A couple ways you can do it. You can call us up because you know we want to hear from you. 407-919-1067, 877-919-1067. We will not put this on social media because y'all fight with each other. Now, if you want to text it over, we'll read it. The XL Mobile is 41067. And if you're watching us now on the live stream, and that's us in the studio doing what we do, got a party appeal in there right now, you can drop a comment there and we will read it. All right? So our thing, why are you mad? 407-919-1067, 877-919-1067. And one of you for calling in, got some tickets to check out the Orlando Pride, Chicago Reds. It's going to be Friday, October 29th, Explorer Stadium. You're going to see some soccer. But first, you got to tell us, why are you mad? We'll find out when we get back here on Johnny's House. 7:55 is Johnny's house.
Stormy day today with highs around 84. Right now it is 71.
We need to find out why you're mad. Anybody here mad about anybody? Anything? Anybody?
No.
Everybody good? Everybody good? All right, we need to find out why are you mad? What has occurred that has you so upset? One of you, we're going to hook you up with a pair of tickets. Check out the Orlando Pride. Chicago Reds starts on Friday, October 29th, Gloria Stadium. We will hook you up just randomly. Hillary, good morning.
Good morning.
Hillary, why are you mad?
So I woke up to a water outage in our area, and so I had no water to get ready this morning. So I'm literally using water bottles that we've had stashed to get my kids stuff ready, to get me ready, to get our dogs ready, like everything.
You didn't get a warning? They didn't tell you anything? Water main break?
Nothing. And nothing. And I went on the website to see because I'm like, I paid the bill. Hello. What's going on?
That's always the first question.
Yeah. And then my husband's like, what is happening? And I'm like, I don't know. And I'm like, I'm barely awake as it is. And I'm like, oh, so I called the emergency line and they're like, oh, yeah, it's an outage. Sorry. Blah, blah, blah. And I'm like, yeah, you're sorry. Okay.
Look, I answer the phone. So what you want me to do? I don't work in the field. I answer the phone. This is what I do.
I understand. Yeah, I get it. But I'm just like, whatever. But so that was nice.
Did this person give you a time when it might be back on?
No, they say in a couple hours, just check in like they, like everybody does.
They say, you go to your sink.
But the checking in thing.
You turn it on.
Right. When it comes on.
It's back.
It's back on.
Yeah. Usually you can start hearing your toilets tink. Yeah. Like, that little trinkle thing. And that's how you know it comes back on. Yeah. Yeah. So I was like, so I had to leave for work. And so I'm like, good luck to you, sir, to my husband. And I'm like, you get to finish it all up. I'm done. I got to get to work. Then on the way to work here, there's a crash. So I'm sitting here, too, waiting on this crash to get through.
Well listen, I'm going to give you a pair. I'm going to give you a pair of tickets. Check out the Pride Red this Friday. It sounds like you could use it. You could use it. You got a lot of stuff going on. It's not even 8 o'clock yet. Holly, good morning.
Good morning, guys.
Holly, why are you mad?
I am so mad because I had my identity stolen from Facebook.
Oh, no.
Oh, it has been horrible. Like, someone got into my checking account. Someone got into my phone. Got, 15 different Facebook accounts out there. One's in Spanish, and I don't know nothing about Spanish. And then they got into my phone somehow, and one day my phone kept going on, off, on, off, on, off. Then it comes across the screen. I am not lying to you guys, and it says, ha ha, you will never catch me.
That is so
man. Man.
Oh that to me is like, that's personal.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh, yeah, it is.
Yeah. Wow. Now what information did they get from Facebook that they can do all that?
Evidently, when you have your phone hooked to Facebook and you pay your bills on the phone, they can go through that way and get into your checking account, and they wiped me out.
Oh,
there was charges in Germany.
Oh,
dang.
Dang. Well, listen, that last lady, Hillary, I'm going to take your tickets back. I'm going to hook her up. No, we didn't get away from her yesterday. Hook her up, too.
Okay.
Goodness. Damn.
So be careful with Facebook, y'all.
It's good that you can laugh about it.
Yeah.
It is.
You have to now.
You have to. Damn, when they say, ha-ha, ain't nothing you can do about it, that's just mean. Be what they saying over there, man.
Let's see, XL Mobile powered by attorney Dan Newland and a wreck. Need a check call, Dan Newland. Someone said they're mad because their ex-boyfriend decided to let them know he didn't want to date no more by changing the Facebook relationship status, but not telling me in person.
Oh. Wow.
I'm mad about that, too.
That's
so childish.
Yeah. You have every reason to be mad.
Do you message him and like, hey, is this an accident? Like, how'd this happen?
Oh, no, if he did that, he ain't picking up the phone.
Yeah.
That's
a hint.
Yeah, you just got ghosted.
And that, notifies all your friends and all that.
Well, here's the thing. If somebody you're dating changes the status, what is to talk about? There's nothing to talk about. That's over.
Right.
But you didn't tell me that this is over.
Yeah, they deserve an explanation still.
Nobody deserves anything.
They do.
If they had the respect for you, they'd talk to you. The mere fact they did that, there's nothing to talk about.
And you shouldn't want to talk to them anyway.
Really? Really? Just go do better.
You can do better.
You can do better.
I am Ed Sheeran.
This is Ariana Grande.
What's up, everybody? This is Justin Bieber. It's Excel.
106.7. Now, the Johnny's House Entertainment News with Ray.
Stop shaving today, dial #250 and say the keywords ideal image. So the latest on the Alec Baldwin shooting incident, I don't know if you saw the little press conference that happened yesterday, but police are continuing to investigate, obviously, what happened to the cinematographer that was killed and the director that was injured. So what they're saying is that the film's armorer, the Hannah Gutierrez Reed lady that everybody's been talking about, told the police that day of the shooting that she checked the ammo in the gun. They were all dummy rounds. She also said that there were never live rounds on set. Mm-hmm. This is according to her.
Yeah.
Never were there live rounds on set.
Yeah.
She claimed that she locked the gun in a safe during lunch that day and taken out just before the shooting. So it was in the safe. They went to lunch, came back. She took it out of the safe. But she did say that there were other people who had access to the safe.
And let me tell you who they were.
Well, that's not very safe.
No. For real. So, assistant director David Halls is the man who handed the gun to Baldwin and declared it was cold, which we all know now means it's not dangerous. Mm-hmm. He says that he remembers seeing three rounds in the gun, but he didn't check all the chambers. Obviously, there's like, what, six chambers in it? Which he should have. He should have checked all of them.
It wasn't like it was 100 chambers. Like,
I don't understand. Why would you just open it, look at three rounds, and then that's it? Like, you need to check. Yeah. You are literally going to shoot this gun in a film.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so after the shooting, he inspected the gun and found four dummy rounds, plus what appeared to be a spent live round, although that's not confirmed just yet, but police do believe that some of the ammo they confiscated from the location was live. So, I mean, right now, it's getting ugly. It's
it
going to get ugly because it's going to be, she did this, he did that, she did this, who did that, you know? So,
Well, you know the conspiracies are out. And I heard one. I don't believe this one. They said that she was making a documentary about pedophilia in Hollywood.
And so someone wanted her dead?
Yeah.
I mean,
whoa.
I'm not surprised that stuff's out there.
I got that from TikTok. Consider the source.
Well, the first one was that Alec Baldwin had pissed off some of the crew
because of the safety.
They set him up.
Yeah.
That was the first one that was going around.
They
did it on purpose. But I'm like, no matter if you're mad at Alec Baldwin, who sets him up to kill a person?
People are innocent.
Yeah.
Oh, my gosh. Those theories are crazy.
Oh, that's just two. I'm sure there's about a million more.
Yeah. As far as possible charges, police haven't ruled anyone out yet, but that's all they are saying as of right now. Now, because they're saying anyone. So Alec Baldwin could be at fault here, too, as well.
Oh, yeah.
There are the People Choice Awards that have came out. They announced their nominees yesterday, and their voting is currently open, and the show's airing live on December 7th. This is if you still care about... How do you think people feel about the People's Choice Awards? I mean, because this is like the people...
This was supposed to be the one. Yeah.
This would probably be the one that people, I think, care the most about.
Because they're voting.
Yeah, mm-hmm. yeah. So for the nominees for movie categories, F9 leads with eight nominations. Including movie of 2021. And actor Vin Diesel, Charlize Theron, and John Cena, they have like a ton of nominations. Black Widow is up there with six nominations. So again, if you want to check it out, we've got it on December 7th.
Fast and Furious. Oh, yeah, I saw that one. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. I can see that.
Did you see that Kevin Hart is putting the whole sex tape scandal to rest now?
It's already to rest.
Nope, it wasn't because his friend was still up against charges. So he was still having to go through this whole chapter in his life where that video was out. So finally, he's putting this whole scandal to rest because now his former friend has been cleared of all criminal wrongdoing in the case.
Cleared?
All clear. So, I mean, even though this is probably not the outcome that he wanted, he said that he is happy that this chapter in his life is over. He's happy that we're able to put a period on this sentence and move on. So this is kind of a big win for his former friend, who Kevin believed tried to extort him over the video in 2017 in the Las Vegas hotel room.
Yeah, I believe his friend tried to extort him. I just love that he tried to blame other people for him doing that. Talking about if y'all would have been available, I wouldn't have cheated.
Isn't that wild? That's crazy.
And people were like, that's right, Kev.
Uh-huh. I'm
like,
what?
So the first three of his charges were dropped due to insufficient evidence.
Yeah.
This was back in 2019. But now they're saying that he had been hit with four charges, unauthorized use of personal ID and identity theft. All of this.
Oh, they got it for something else.
But all of this has
Nothing to do with
nothing.
It.
The yeah. final charge for identity theft has gone the same way. Insufficient evidence. So wow. there was not enough evidence to charge this dude. And so he's just walking away with nothing.
Well, what it does for Kevin is it basically told him, you can't trust anybody.
You can't.
You can't.
Absolutely not.
This is your friend. And he was jealous of your fame. So he's going to... Hey, today is one of those special days. You know how every day has a title. This is one. And we're going to celebrate and tell you what that is next right here on Johnny's House. Thursday morning is 8:09, and this is Johnny's House.
It's going to be a stormy day today with highs around 84. Right now it is 71.
Crazy about this storm. It's reeling in, but it's a beautiful morning so far.
It's nice
out. But they say it's rolling in here. So.
Yeah, the sunrise is pretty.
Be on the lookout. Today is one of those special days. Ray, what is today?
Today is National First Responders Day.
All right, and what job is considered a first responder?
I mean...
I would say firefighters.
Police officers.
EMTs.
I don't know. I don't know if nurses are. I would imagine not, because they don't necessarily respond.
So like paramedics.
They said it may seem like registered nurses working in the ER or trauma department would be considered first responders, but generally they are not, since this occurs in a hospital setting.
Yeah, I would imagine anyone that reports to a scene.
Yeah.
Like they're the first to show up.
Yeah. So today is, and what we want to do is shout out the EMT, firefighters, police officers. If you are in a relationship or married to them, let people understand what you're going through. My big, correspondents are with firefighters when my house burned down. And I was so impressed that, you know, I've never had to deal with firefighters, but they worked as a team. They had signals going on. And I wish I knew her name. It was one firefighter. She came to me and said, hey, we're going to do everything you can. Is there any medicines or anything that I said, yeah, my son needs some. And they're on the counter. Now, you got to understand, that's flames shooting out of the roof of the house. And they got hoses all in there. And she tells me, do you know where they are? I said, yeah, if it's in the kitchen, if you go in to the right and they're on the counter. And she said, okay, put a mask on. Came back out. Are these it? And we found more. So they jammed in a bag. And then one lady said, listen, we tried to save this. And it was my iPad. It got a little wet. And they handed it to me. I'm just like, wow, man. I was just blown away. Now, I have nothing but the utmost respect and love for firefighters. And I wish I knew the company that came to my house, because I'd love to go over and just treat you guys to dinner, even though it's after the fact. I was just blown away. And, Ray, you are married to a first responder.
Yeah.
And how is it being married to one?
It's fun, yeah. I guess, but it's also a massive struggle every single day, just because it's like, you know, the schedule is kind of all over the place. You don't know what they're going to encounter every single day. Mm-hmm. Sometimes they have to work late. You never know when they're going to come home.
Are you fearful?
Yeah. Because
is it something you just deal with every day?
Every single day. It's like, you know, you always kiss them goodbye and hope that they come back home that day.
Yeah.
So luckily for me, like, my wife is a detective. So now she's kind of just in the office, but she is still like, she goes out to a crime scene and does the investigation and all that stuff. So I'm lucky right now that she doesn't have to be on the road.
Yeah.
But I do have a lot of friends that are still on the road. Mm-hmm. And, you know, it's insane what they do, because when everybody else is running the other way, they're running towards, you know, the crime scene and the danger and all of that. So it takes a special person to be a first responder. And I don't, you know, even I have a friend, Marcus, he's a firefighter, and I don't understand.
Oh, yeah.
Like, they're like different types of human beings.
They kicked in that door. They had holes in their hand. And I'm like, yeah, there's a big fire.
Yeah. They are true life, like, superheroes. You know, they're there for you whenever things are going wrong. And so I just, you know, I have so much respect for first responders, for sure.
All right. So we want you to shout out if you know one, married to one, friends to one, co-workers. We want to shout out first responders. Right now, give them the love that they deserve on their day. 407-919-1067, 877-919-1067, because we want to talk to you. If you want to put it on social media so everybody can see it, what you got, we got. We can put it up there. If you want to text over and not talk to us, our XL Mobile is 41067. And if you're part of the large group of people that are watching our show every day on the Johnny's House live stream, you can drop a comment there. But we are shouting out, it is First Responders Day, and we're shouting out and giving love to first responders. We want to hear from you. 407-919-1067, 877-919-1067. We're giving love to the first responders right here on Johnny's House. Hold on, young Brock. It has to.
I saw you take the bite, and I go, oh,
that's. Why you tell me to stop?
Bad decision. Bad decision. Seven seconds left.
I got to thank your wife. She brought his, what is it, like,
it's like a pumpkin spice roll.
Oh, you guys like pumpkin. And we're sitting here just talking, and mm-hmm. What about my baby?
Oh, my goodness. I saw you put that bite in your mouth. I'm like, why did he do that?
All of a sudden, Brian just leans over casually, points at me like, uh-oh. Young Brack.
I'm pretty sure I swallowed my piece whole because I knew the song was about to end. I'm surprised I didn't choke on that.
Young broadcasters, don't do this. You will lose your job.
I'm mad because mine's gone. It's delicious.
You will lose your job. 8:22, this is Johnny's house.
It's going to be a stormy day today with highs around 84. Right now it is 71.
Today is First Responders Day. Now we're having some dispute on who are considered first responders. Now I'm going by what I looked up.
Yeah, I looked it up.
I looked it up on Google and said first responders are normally police officers, EMTs, and firefighters.
The first people on the scene of an accident or a situation.
Police officer jobs include responding to emergency calls when out on patrol, at which point they require the CPR, first aid, blah, 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 blah. Now, there's some people, it's like, prison guards. I don't know.
Well, I mean, no, chronologically, you're the last responder. Yeah. Because, see, whatever already happened, and they're in jail now. Now, I mean, if a situation does jump off in jail, though, they would be the first to respond.
Yeah. So. Someone said a school nurse. I mean,
they're the first to respond to your kid at school.
True that?
That's true, I guess.
True that? All right, so we want to do some...
Technically, guys. On our show, you're a first responder.
Yeah,
because you're the first one to respond to people.
So shout out to me!
When they call in.
I'm just kidding. Firefighters, EMT, like, come on, y'all, seriously.
Just, you guys.
Seriously.
In a meeting, I'm a first responder, because I'm the first one to yell out a smart comment when someone says something stupid.
Listen, everybody has their day, okay? And I'm sure they have radio phone screen a day.
Probably not. There's not even really a radio personality day.
That's true. What do we got? All of them did what? Radio day?
National radio day, yeah.
Kirsten, good morning.
Good morning.
Who would you like to shout out on National Responders Day?
So I wanted to shout out my boyfriend. He's a firefighter, and that he's worked very hard to get where he's at, and I'm very proud of him.
Very good. And how is it being dating a firefighter? How is it for you?
It's fine. It's just different because they work 24 hours. So in those times, like, everything's your responsibility, like in the house and, you know, if you have animals or kids and stuff like that. Yeah.
I will say this about firefighters, because we do play them when the cheap shots get back. We play them in charity basketball. Most of the firefighters, I say 90% of them, have beautiful wives.
That's true.
They really do.
Yeah.
Huh?
I would have to agree.
You see them walking, you're like, well, who the hell are they?
I'm like.
So my son is 16. He just recently talked about starting to look into being a fireman, and that was one of the things he listed as a reason.
Stop.
I'm not kidding. Well, I mean, he thinks it's a great job. He thinks it changes every day, which he loves. It has great benefits, and they all have hot girlfriends.
They do?
That's what he said.
Hey, I'm just outside of looking in.
No,
I'm just
it's like, there, yeah.
And we play them every year. We're like, man, who are those? Oh, those are our wives and girlfriends. Really? Okay. All right. Mm-hmm. Well, shout out to him. You can say his name. Have you said his name? You can say it.
Yeah, sure. His name's Tyler.
Okay, Tyler. All right. Thank you for sharing that, Kirsten.
Thank you, guys.
Bye-bye. Oh, yeah. Alexis, good morning.
Good morning.
First responder day. Well, who would you like to shout out?
My husband, Blake. He's a police officer.
Okay. And how is it being married to a police officer?
Honestly, it depends on the day. Okay. Like, some days are easier than other days. Like Ray said, you just never know what they're going to get into and what kind of, you know, moods or whatever they're going to come home with. So it just depends on the day.
Yeah, because you don't know what they've seen that day.
Yeah.
You know.
Exactly.
They've seen some things that you can't even imagine.
I can't fathom them. Like, he, you know, you have to be there to vent for them to vent to you, like, be there to listen. And it's some of the things that they see and do is I can't even imagine.
Yeah. All right, well, have a good day there, Blake. Thank you, Alexis.
Thank you.
All right, let's see. Lauren, good morning.
Good morning.
All right, it is National First Responders Day. Who would you like to shout out?
I'd like to give a shout out to my husband, Steven. He's a school resource officer in St. Cloud.
Okay. And how is it being married to a school resource officer?
He works at a middle school, and to be honest with you, this has been the most normal our schedule. Been since he's been a police officer. He was on the road for 5 years. Mm-hmm. So we do have the luxury of a Monday through Friday schedule, mm-hmm. but he does like to help with extracurricular school activities. I've just seen a change in him because I've seen that he's basically found his life's purpose in making a positive impact on the kids that he interacts with every day and giving them someone positive to look up to and someone who encourages them. So it's been a huge change for going from patrol to resource officer. I think he's really found his life's passion, and I'm so proud of him
for
having the heart to do something like that.
Because if it was me, I'd be like, these bad kids.
It takes the patience of a saint. It does. I don't think I could do it.
He's bad, man.
He's cut from the right cloth.
Very good. And it sounds like you're really proud of him. It sounds great.
I am. I could not be more proud of him. He worked through the part-time academy for 11 months, going to work full-time and going to school part-time, and he decided that's what he wanted to do with his life, and he has made himself a success story, and I could not be more proud.
Good for you. Everybody wants to hear the woman talking about them like that. All right. Thank you, Lauren.
Thank you very much. Have a great day.
You too. Let's see. Cassie.
Hi. Good morning, guys.
It is First Responders Day. Who would you like to shout out?
My husband, Ryan, who is a newly promoted captain with Polk County Fire Rescue.
Whoa, congratulations, nice. Ryan. Wow. And how does it feel to be married to now a captain of the fire department?
It's a lot more responsibility on his shoulders, and he's at a brand new station that's getting ready to have their grand opening, so he's excited about that with a new crew.
Wow.
It's a whole new ball game, but he is loving it so far, and it's good. Yeah, more responsibility, but he likes it, and he likes his new crew. So far, so good.
Well, congratulations to the captain. Tell him we said hello.
Yeah.
Okay.
I will.
Mm-hmm. Be what they say.
Let's see. XL More powered by attorney Dan Newland. Interrect need a check. Call Dan Newland. Someone said their husband, Matthew Small, he's an EMT in Lake County.
Mm-hmm.
Works tons of hours. So shout out to him. Someone's brother is a trauma critical care flight medic.
Woo!
So they're on the helicopter that
goes
out.
Oh, my goodness.
Yeah.
Which is crazy. Someone said their whole second family, the Orange County Fire Department.
Hello, hello.
They said, look, honestly, you don't think about it, but they're eating dinner, grocery shopping, working out, going to the bathroom. When the tone drops, it's go time.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. I see the young, there's a fire department near me. I see the young guy in there shopping for groceries.
Yeah, I always see him in the neighborhood, too.
And they're shopping. Detroit, what are they saying over there on the Johnny's House live stream?
Lots of people on the live stream just saying thank you to first responders. Douglas says thank you for your service. God bless you all. Please be safe. Ashley shouting out her brother, dad, cousin, and uncle. They are all current or former firefighters. So she said shout out to the City of Orlando Fire Department and the Polk family firemen. And then Jeffrey said his younger sister, Nicole, just graduated last week to become a firefighter down in Miami.
All right. Well, listen, all you first responders, if no one tells you, we appreciate you and enjoy your day and be safe out there. What?
The mobile's killing me.
Hold on. Let me see. I know it's something I can't say on the air.
No, you can say it, but I'm not going to, but you could. It's just funny.
Yo.
Number one?
Yeah. Yes.
I'm not saying that. If y'all want to say it, you can't.
I'm not going to.
This is a stretch, y'all.
They said they're first responders.
Yeah.
Flight attendants. Sure. All right, listen, we come back. We're going to find out. Everybody loves.
Hey, when you hit that little button, boom.
They're right there first to respond.
Who shows up first?
That's right. They're first to respond. All right, listen, we come back. We know everybody loves Halloween. We want to find out why you hate it. Why you hate Halloween. We're going to talk about that next on Johnny's House.
Boom. Can I help you, sir?
8:37 is the time. It's Johnny's house.
It's going to be a stormy day today with highs around 84. Right now it is 71.
Someone texted and told me it was Orange County Fire Department 30, 31, and 33. Yeah, it was a free trucker that responded to my house fire. If someone can tell me if that's correct, just email me and let me know, because I'd like to go down and say what's up to the fellas and the ladies that did that. All right, now, there's a lot of people looking forward to Halloween. Some people like Halloween is their thing. That is their one.
That's my wife's jam.
That's her jam. That is it.
She don't care about Christmas.
Yes.
She don't care about, I mean, she likes Thanksgiving because, you know, but we're going to a football game this
year.
Yes. Like, but Halloween, she loves.
That is it. Ray, on your list of holidays, where's Halloween?
I like fall in general.
Okay.
So as soon as fall hits, like, I appreciate the hay rides, the pumpkin patches, all the festivities.
Hey, fall's going to hit us about, I think, about 6:45 this afternoon.
No, fall has already started. So when fall has started on the calendar, that is when it started, and that's when the festivities happen, and that's what I appreciate the most, and I love that.
Okay. And Halloween in general?
I like it.
I
like it because I like to dress up. I like to have fun. I like to see the kids have fun. Mm-hmm. So I do appreciate it.
And Detroit, where is it on your list?
I just don't really care about Halloween.
Yeah.
I don't hate it. Like, I don't dislike it. I don't care about it.
Really?
I don't care to dress up. That's like putting too much effort into something that I just don't really care about.
Yeah.
Like, I liked Halloween when I was in high school and I could go, like, illegally get drunk in somebody's basement. But now it's just like,
My old neighborhood, I liked Halloween a lot. The kids came through. We sit out on the curb so people didn't have to walk to the house, and people come by, tons of kids, trick-or-treat, holler, you know. And then about 8 o'clock, that's when the old kids came by. Even though they didn't see a light, they knocked on your door anyway.
Oh, yeah.
And you just pretend you're not there. Now, my new neighborhood, maybe because it was COVID, left a little bad taste in my mouth, where they came by in golf carts. And went and blew the horn.
Yeah, like last year, I think maybe distancing messed that up.
You think so?
Yeah, I'd give it one more year.
Yep.
Now, they do it again this year.
Chuck the candy at them.
Then there's a bunch of little spoiled punks.
I'm serious, man. I've been thinking about not participating. I've never not participated in Halloween. Even when I lived in an apartment and nobody ever came.
Well, you got snotty kids in your neighborhood.
Maybe they were just snotty last year. I don't know.
Oh.
I mean,
maybe they were social distancing on the golf cart.
Yeah, that's what it was.
What they were doing.
Oh, they were 8 deep on the golf cart. And they had lights on it and music and all that.
They knew each other.
Yeah,
so.
I'm just picturing Johnny standing at like the top of his driveway arguing with a kid. You come down here. No, you come up here.
No, I looked out the door. They're like, hey. And then I just closed the door back. They kind of got the message.
Yeah, they're going to egg your house.
And then at the end of the night, I'm sitting here with like 60 little bags made up. So I put a little table out there on the street and said, take one. Watch the go-kart come up. Meep, meep. Took them all. So I left a little bad taste in my mouth.
Yeah.
So I'm not even thinking about participating. If the kids say, hey, maybe we should give out some candy this year, I'll just go up and get a bag.
And he doesn't want to trick-or-treat or go out and get candy?
He's at that age now. Yeah. He didn't say yes, but he didn't say no. But he never asked about a costume, so I don't think we're going to.
How does Jaden feel about it at his age?
He wants to go out and hang out. Like, he just wants to hang out with his friends.
Yeah.
Like, I don't care. He knows he's going to get some candy, even if it's just leftovers at my house. But he just wants to go hang out with his friends, I think. I don't think he cares either way.
I want to find out why you hate Halloween. You just don't like it. I mean, it could be a religious thing. You know, it's just not one of those things you like, but you just don't like it. You don't like the fact that there's kids, that people that come, strange kids, people come to your neighborhood. Because, listen, I used to go to the rich neighborhoods when I was growing up, because my neighborhood had no good candy.
Oh, yeah, we went to
lived in that neighborhood. I knew they weren't giving out no good stuff.
Yeah. Well, we did our neighborhood first.
Yeah.
And then we piled in the car and went to the other neighborhoods. Because our neighborhood was a quick stop. It wasn't much there.
Yeah, Smarties and Pal bubble gum. That's real cheap stuff. It's stuff you get at Family Dollars, which is a good place to get candy because it's cheap.
Yeah.
But we used to go to the rich neighborhoods.
Us too.
And if you live in that rich neighborhood, you're looking at the kids like, I know y'all don't live in this neighborhood.
Yeah, there ain't that many kids in here.
So I want to find out why you do not like Halloween. It's just not your thing. You know, people act all crazy and dress all different, and you just don't like it. Why don't you like Halloween? 407-919-1067, 877-919-1067. You can text and let us know why. And no, if someone says they don't like Halloween, that's their choice. Don't go back and forth and yell at them. It's their choice. We're asking them to tell us. You ain't got to comment and say, you stupid. And y'all do stuff like that.
Yeah, they do.
It's okay. Or you can text the XL Mobile. It's 41067. If you're watching us do the show live on the live stream, if you haven't, what you waiting on? There's a little family in there that get together every day. And you can drop a comment there. What is it about it? Why don't you like Halloween? And for being honest, we're going to hook somebody up with a pair of tickets to see Dan and Shay Thursday, November 4th at the Amway Center. Tickets available at the Amway Center box office and Ticketmaster. Explain to us why you hate Halloween. We'll have those answers when we get back here, and it should be about 8:52. 852, Orlando's number one hit music station. It's XL 106.7 in Johnny's house.
It's going to be a stormy day today with highs around 84. Right now it is 71.
It's getting a little gray out there. It's getting a little gray. I'm looking right now. We're looking at Fox 35, the storm team. They're like, hey, yeah, everything. During the storm coverage, God forbid, you got a tornado. I'm reading exactly what they have on the teleprompter. A couple blocks away, you can stream your mobile app device right here, live from our storm coverage 35 Storm Center. It's all inclusive. This is awesome. I guess they want you to get their app.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Or you could just download the iHeartRadio app.
Oh, I like the fact they can tell you what city. If you live in Bushnell, you're going to start feeling some rain in 1 minute.
Let me stop. That was Tom Terry's jam. Like Tom Terry's the OG of telling you what time it's going
to
hit.
I'll never forget the first time I ran in one. I was listening to, I was watching Tom Terry. He goes, I think I was in Longwood. In Longwood, you'll start feeling the effects in 8 minutes. I'm like, please. Ain't nothing.
Yeah.
Whoa!
Hey, Tom Terry loosens up that tie.
Yes.
It's over.
Takes the jacket off.
Mm-hmm, it's good to go. All right, we want to find out. Why you hate Halloween? You know, what's the deal? What's going on there? Jesse, good morning.
Good morning.
Why don't you like Halloween?
I am scared of so many things, and Halloween is like just spooky time and all of the advertisements. And you guys talk about ghost stories, and I have to change the station. Like, I cannot listen to that kind of stuff and not have nightmares, so I just get scared of everything.
They're not real.
I used to think that Detroit was the scariest person in the world, but I think you might have a beat, Jesse. You scared of everything?
Yeah. Well,
I mean, only around Halloween time. Like, it's just kind of a spooky, like, the Halloween episodes of shows and, like, the theme parks that do the really, really scary events and all of those ads that start coming out around this time, all the scary movies. I can't see them. I can't listen to it. It just scares me.
So we talk about ghost stories on the air, and this is not like it's a night show. It's a day. You got stuff to do. You change the channel on us?
I have to. I can't, because then later that night I'm sitting there on the couch like, oh my gosh, this one person called and said that there was a real ghost. Like, I can't listen to it and not think about it later.
I was going to scare you right now, but that wouldn't be cool.
I find that stuff kind of fascinating.
That's the thing.
What's that?
Like, you can't, I don't jump scare. Like, if you just sneak up on me and try to spook me, it doesn't work. Like, I don't freak out if people jump out at me. But anything that just gives that, like, creepy vibe, like ghost stories and things like that, I can't listen.
Now, are you not giving out candy? Are you not participating? What are you doing?
I don't mind the trick-or-treaters, but really, I live in a neighborhood that doesn't have any, and I kind of wish we did, because that's the fun part.
Yeah.
You know, that's cute. Like, little kids dressing up in costumes, that's adorable. I can handle that. Uh-huh. But, like, somebody, you know, I go into the Halloween store, I have to stay away from the scary displays, but, like, I can handle the costumes.
Do you drink a lot of coffee?
No. I just get really excited.
Yeah.
I mean, you're rolling. You know, we can sit back and you can just go for it, girl. Listen, we're going to hook you up with a pair of tickets.
You know,
go ahead.
Everybody talks about how much they love Halloween, and it's, you know, then I'm like the Grinch over here of Halloween. Like, oh, I hate it because it's scary. You know, all my friends go to all the fun things, and I'm like, nope, I don't want any part
of
that.
Jesse, are you in a relationship?
I am.
Okay.
You sound like that at one time at band camp, girl.
Yeah, she does.
Okay, I've definitely been told that before.
Well, we're going to hook you up with a pair of tickets to see Dan and Shay Thursday, November 4th at the Amway. You take that significant other and try not to talk through the whole concert.
I'll do my best.
Okay. You hold on, okay?
She has a zest for life.
I know. I mean, she was rolling, man. Samantha, good morning.
Good morning, guys. How are you?
Why don't you like Halloween?
I don't even like it when October 1st rolls around, because then everything scary comes on the TV. And nope, I don't like it. I can't stand it. My husband and I both don't like it. We call them boo movies, scary stuff, whatever, however you want to call it. We don't. Nope. Nope. I'm not like that. Never have been. My husband either. Poor husband doesn't even like, we took and hit a dead end road one time, and it was a cemetery at the end. He's like, nope, hurry up, turn around. And I'm like, it's fine. It's the middle of the day. Nope, turn around. I mean, we don't,
we
have kids.
Are you going to go trick-or-treating or give out candy?
No, we do like the fall festivals.
Oh, yeah, trunk-or-treat.
Trunk-or-treat. During the day.
Yeah,
but as far as nighttime stuff, hell no.
What, you just turn the lights off and pretend you're not home?
I do. I told my kids, I said, you know, y'all can go with friends that do that kind of stuff. Like, my husband doesn't even like corn mazes. Nope, doesn't like it. And I'm sitting there going, turn off all the lights, be quiet, and don't say nothing. And of course, then the dogs bark, and I'm sitting there going, shut up. I don't want no one knowing we're home.
Nope, okay. We don't do it.
Well, it looked like you found your perfect mate then.
18 years, honey. Yes, yeah. I did. And David's the one, I'm calling for Mount Verde. David's the one that asked you, do you know where Mount Verde is? And he said, Ocala.
Oh.
Nope, that ain't
anywhere near
it.
Yes.
You guys know who David is. He's the guy that calls with the accent and the funny sayings all the time. Well, he used to call all the time.
Yeah.
Yep, that's him.
Well, listen, y'all have a safe and private Halloween, okay?
Oh, yes, we will. Lights out, baby.
Tell David we said hello.
I will, hon. Thank you. See. Y'all be good.
Okay, bye-bye. Be what they're saying over there.
XMO, powered by attorney Dan Newland. Interrec, need to check. Call Dan Newland. Someone said they're not a fan because they just don't see the need to celebrate. Like, what are we celebrating? Someone says it's hypocritical. All year long, we teach kids to not take candy from strangers. And then today, we tell them take candy from strangers.
I don't think that message is that confusing.
Teaches kids how to beg.
Dang. Detroit, what are they saying over there? Goodness.
On the live stream, Eric said it's just all the negative responses that are associated with it. Another person said they just don't like horror, the dark side of Halloween, but the candy and kids and the fun stuff is fine.
Okay, well, if you're celebrating, it's a couple days away. If not, make sure you turn your lights off so the kids don't come by. Ms. Ray, what's going on, girl?
Adam Levine is kind of getting some backlash after a fan jumped up on stage and his reaction.
His reaction was awesome.
Yeah.
Oh, I got to hear about this. Coming up 3 minutes, Johnny's house.
XL 1067 has your chance at $1,000 and a VIP trip to our iHeartRadio Jingle Ball. Now, text the nationwide keyword, LIGHTS, LIGHTS, to 200-200. You'll get a confirmation text and info. Standard data and message rates apply in this nationwide contest. That's LIGHTS to 200-200. Good luck.
What's up? This is Billie Eilish.
What's up, everybody? This is Justin Bieber.
This is Dua Lipa.
Now, the Johnny's House Entertainment News with Ray.
All right, so if you haven't seen this video going around on social media, it's all over the place, but Adam Levine was performing on stage when a fan jumped up on stage. Don't know how she got up there. And ran up to him while he was singing and performing and hugged him.
Okay.
And so his reaction is what people are kind of like hating him on. So he like realizes that he like was just hugged by a girl, didn't hug her back, obviously, because he was performing, but he like dropped the F-bomb and he like shook it off like she was like disgusting. Like he was just like, ugh, like,
she,
you know.
She kind of rolled up from the back, so he was surprised.
Yeah. Oh, it startled him for sure.
In his defense. But then after he walked away, he started doing like the shudder like she was gross.
Maybe it's a COVID thing.
She had a mask on.
Oh, yeah, it could be.
But I mean, not that's okay.
Yeah.
People were saying that you don't appreciate your fans. All they do is make you rich and that you are like disgusted with your fans. Like all these things that people were saying. But he finally came out on an Instagram video, which I feel like he shouldn't have to. But he said, I've always been someone that loves, respects, worships our fans. Without our fans, we don't have a job. He said, I just need you guys to know I was really startled. And sometimes when you're startled, you have to shake it off and move on because I'm doing my job up there. It's what I pride myself on.
You ever see somebody get on stage at a rap concert?
Woo! Oh, they get beat down.
They get beat down.
Like, tackled off stage.
And thrown back in the crowd.
And that's the thing. Like, she got escorted off the stage, of course.
Yeah, but at a rap show, I mean, literally everybody would have got a hit in. Like the dude selling programs would have ran down there and got a hit in real quick.
Isn't
like,
that crazy?
Yes. Yeah.
So, I mean, I hate that he's getting backlash for it, but he apologized and everything like that. But yeah, she got on stage and he needs to have a conversation with his security.
That was just about to come out of my mouth. Yeah.
Whoever was in charge.
No, because she got up there pretty much uninhibited. Like if she were crazy and wanted to kill him, she could have stabbed him right in the throat.
She could have. Immediately.
Just like that.
Just like that.
Yeah, that's not cool.
So Angelina Jolie, obviously, she is like doing all of these interviews for Eternals. This is like a very highly anticipated film for her.
Yeah.
It's a Marvel Cinematic Universe movie. So she has been bringing her kids to all the red carpets and all that stuff. But when she was doing an interview with E!, they asked her, were the kids more excited for your Eternal movie or were your kids more excited that you're friends with The Weeknd? Because, you know, she's been spotted with The Weeknd over and over again. And so they were kind of like questioning what kind of relationship that was. And she kind of just blew it off, obviously.
Of course.
She was like, listen, if there's anything more impressive than your mom being a superhero, it's obviously that she could be dating one of the biggest pop stars. But she was like, yeah, they're very excited about the film.
Okay.
And so, you know, obviously they've been spotted multiple times. Mm-hmm. And if she is, her friends are saying that she's, you know, just trying to have fun. She's making up for lost time and she's out there. No pressure or expectations at this point. Just wants to have fun with The Weeknd.
I'd be that guy on the red carpet trying to make a name for myself. And kids, what do you think about mom's new movie? Good. Magic, what do you think about
she was out with her ex-husband, her first ex-husband, the next night after The Weeknd and left with him.
Oh.
So, look, she's Angelina Jolie. She'll do what she wants to do.
Oh, yeah.
Exactly. Yeah. And if she wants to go out, let her have some fun. I mean, she's got six freaking kids.
Oh, yeah.
And she got that voodoo. She'll just take whoever she wants.
Still rolling with it. All right, let's find out what's trending. We'll do that next on Johnny's House. 9:09 is the time. It is Thursday morning. This is Johnny's house.
It's going to be a stormy day today with highs around 84. Right now it is 74.
Detroit, what is trending, ma'am?
As we mentioned earlier, today is National First Responders Day. Mm-hmm. So make sure you thank a first responder.
Absolutely.
It's also National Chocolate Day.
Is it really?
Yeah, which is pretty exciting.
Chocolate's all right for me. It's all right.
I love chocolate.
I like dark chocolate.
I love all chocolate. I don't discriminate against my chocolates. I love chocolate.
It's all right.
Yeah. All kinds of chocolate.
Yeah, that's okay. I like the caffeine kick that it has in chocolate. That's about it. Yeah.
Forgot caffeine just like makes you go crazy.
I need it, man. Yeah.
That's wild. I never think about caffeine being in chocolate.
No, me neither.
Also trending, this is disgusting, to say the least, but apparently there's going to be hot dog flavored candy canes just in time for the holidays. What hot dogs have to do with the holidays, I don't know. This is easily one of the most disgusting things I've ever heard of. And the most shocking part is that they are already sold out, which is insane to me. I am so shocked that that many people want hot dog flavored candy canes.
It's got to be like a gag gift.
It has to be.
I don't know. But it is from a company, Archie McPhee. And apparently they sell candy cane flavors that are just odd for a while now. Like some of their other flavors, they have bacon, sardines, ketchup, kale, pickles, pizza, mac and cheese. So
that company would never get any money from me.
Yeah. That's just like a gimmick type thing.
I don't know. It's so crazy, but you can check them out at McPhee.com if you are interested. But then it's funny because then I saw there was an article that came out about the top things you'd rather do instead of eating a candy cane flavored hot dog. Something like
anything.
Lick the floor of a phone booth. Attend a Nicolas Cage film festival.
Hey!
Spend the night in an unventilated room with Post Malone. So I thought those were pretty funny. Also, you might see that McDonald's Sprite is trending today. And if you see it, I highly recommend you click on it and just go through all the memes because it's pretty funny. I guess there's a photo that went viral of a computer where somebody said they spilled their drink in it. And it the keyboard is burnt. The screen is burnt. Everybody's saying, oh, they must have had a McDonald's Coke because... Yeah. Or not McDonald's Coke, McDonald's Sprite, because when you drink it, it burns. Because it's kind of like,
The carbonation is so strong.
Yeah, which is great. I never noticed that McDonald's Coke is any different, or Sprite. I keep saying Coke because I'm so addicted to McDonald's Coke.
Well, I think all of their fountain drinks are different. They're just I think they're better.
And they know it. They say that.
I think they're better, too. Yeah. That's why I was shocked that people are bringing them into this.
I think they're stronger. That's why it has more bite. It has more bite to it.
I love McDonald's Coke. Like, if I could have McDonald's Coke run through my veins, I would.
I go through the drive-thru sometimes just to get a Coke.
I do too. Really? All the time. All the time. It's so good. It is.
And they won't tell you why either.
Oh, it's good.
It has something to do with like the syrup levels and the carbonation that they manipulated it to be
told
different.
Me it's because they're the only ones that still get it in metal containers. Like there's all kinds of theories behind it. I don't know why.
It's so good. Last thing trending, this is pretty cool. So there's a couple that went viral for their engagement photos because most people take them and like a cute setting and a sunset on the beach, something like that. Well, they opted for something different, but something that's personal to them, a grocery store.
Okay.
So when I saw this, I was like, okay, that's a little weird, but the photos are actually really cute. So it's a grocery store called the Berkeley Bowl, which is by their college campus. They met at UC Berkeley. So they said that at the beginning of their relationship, they would always grocery shop together and cook together. So it's meaningful to them, but the photos are really cute. There's some of like them pushing each other in the cart, them posing with like produce in the produce section or scanning each other in the checkout line.
Okay.
I thought it seemed silly, but after looking at the photos, they actually are pretty cute. Yeah.
Okay. I think it all depends on the photographer. You can do a photo shoot anywhere if you got a good photographer.
Yeah, I thought it was cute, though. Good. I like
it. All right, it is Breast Cancer Awareness Month, and like we do every single year, we're going to talk to our favorite doctor, Dr. Sajandia. She has a message that she'd like to get across, and we'll talk to her next on Johnny's House.
Hey, what's up? It's Brian from Johnny's House. You guys know I'm good for at least two or three bad jokes a morning, but I'm also good for those bad jokes in the afternoon as well, along with all your favorites from the 80s, 90s, and today at Magic 107.7, 2 to 7 each weekday.
This traffic center is brought to you by the one and only attorney, Dan Newland.
This report is sponsored by Wawa. Fuel up.
We still have slow traffic on eastbound I-4 right around Osceola Polk Line Road from Osceola Parkway to State Road 535. From Cayley to Colonial and westbound I-4 remains very slow from State Road 434 into Lee Road. Have a serious accident being investigated. It's in the through lane of the rotary northbound on Avalon Park Boulevard at Golden Rain Tree Boulevard. And right lane construction southbound on North Orlando Avenue at West Sibelia Avenue. See traffic problems? Call the SafeTouchSecurity.com traffic tip line at 866-676-8477 from the Traffic Center. I'm Daisy Cash.
Getting closer to the weekend. Are you thinking about doing some car shopping? Let me save you some time. Just one stop is all you need to make. Jenkins Hyundai of Leesburg. See my friend, Steve Tagliente. He's the GM over there. He is going to take care of you. He and his crew, they are the best. Going to make you feel like part of the family. Going to get you a great car, whether it's a new Hyundai or one of their beautiful pre-owns, the nicest certified pre-owns you'll ever see. Over 500 on the ground to choose from. You are going to love your experience at Jenkins Hyundai of Leesburg. Big in the community, so you...
Thursday morning is 9:22, and this is Johnny's house.
It's going to be a stormy day today with highs around 74. Highs around 84. Right now it is 74.
All right, October is Breast Cancer Awareness Month, and we've been, you know, every year since we've been doing this, far back as I can remember, we have our favorite doctor on the air, and she always has a message she wants to get out. Dr. Sachindia, how are you?
Hey, Johnny, I'm good. How are you guys?
Good. We're not used to seeing, you know, not seeing you. You know, now when you have to go virtual and talk to you. How you been? How's the family?
No, everybody's good. Family's growing up. It's all good. I'm an empty nester for the first time.
Are you really?
Yeah, that's crazy.
How's it feel?
Yes. Oh, it's awful. I'm so sorry. I miss my kids.
Aww.
But, you know, they say it gets better, so I'm going to go with they say.
That's what they say. That's what they say. Yeah, all right, yeah. So what's your message today, Dr. Sachindia?
So, as October began, right, mm-hmm. our first lady, Mrs. DeSantis, was diagnosed with breast cancer.
Yes.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
And that was, obviously, she's 41, she has young kids, and, you know, the one thing I really appreciated about the governor's statement was he said that, you know, she's the cornerstone of our family,
mm-hmm.
right? And that is true of all families, I would think. But the problem is a lot of women are putting themselves at last, and they're not doing what they need to do.
Mm-hmm.
We have that, and then we have the pandemic last year and continuing this year, and it's been a really big issue. I'll give you an example. 85% down last October in women getting their mammogram screening. And that's understandable, wow. right? Because we were kind of still in the tail end or whatever in the midst of all of this.
Yeah.
This October, we're still down by a third of women getting their screening. And the problem is this. There is actually a study that just came out that talked about the next 10 years. They anticipate 10,000 women dying because of the lack of screening over this past year.
Oh, wow.
So we have to start getting a couple of messages out. The first message is it is absolutely safe to go and get your health care.
Yeah.
Go to your doctor's office, get your mammograms done, get your screening done for prostate cancer, whatever. But it is very safe to go to your physicians, right? We know that.
Mm-hmm.
The numbers are down, and we need to encourage women to get that. Second of all, we have another issue, and that is a manpower issue. So when women are calling to try to get their mammograms, sometimes there's a delay,
mm-hmm.
right, because there's a staffing shortage.
Yeah.
But people need to be patient because we're just in difficult times. Mm-hmm. However, people do need to pick up that phone and get their screening mammogram done. And for a screening mammogram, you don't need a script. You don't need a prescription from your doctor.
You can just go get it done.
So, yeah. And most insurance covers a screening mammogram as a preventive thing. So it's usually a covered service.
Women that don't have insurance, because I know a lot of people lost their jobs and probably lost their insurance and medical.
That's true. Yeah, and that's true. So here's the thing. A mammogram costs about $150. All right. And in October, and we still have a few days left,
yeah.
there are still specials running around for like $99, right?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So I would highly encourage women to at least get that done. Think about this. 1 in 7 women get breast cancer in the United States. 85% have no family history. So if you're going to put something towards your health care and you don't have, let's say you don't have financial resources, right?
Yeah.
Then if you save up your money once a year to get your mammogram done.
Mm-hmm.
Because
mm-hmm.
that's an easy fix. And we also know that survival depends on early detection.
Early detection, yeah.
So I know there's probably a grocery trip for a family or whatever.
Yeah.
But that's once a year. But that's a really important thing. And then not only that, if people kind of plan ahead, like I said, October, there's always specials running around.
Mm-hmm.
And it's really the only month. So I would highly encourage people to do that. And the other thing is, you know, one of the other things that was brought up with Mrs. DeSantis is that she, you know, she's young. She's 41. And there's an issue with young women, and they have dense breast tissue. But if you feel a lump or you feel a change, and even if your mammogram is negative, you still need to be checked by a doctor because mammograms can miss 6 to 10% of lesions. It is still the gold standard,
yeah.
but it can miss a lesion. So if you feel something, please get checked out. And it's reassuring because most lumps are not a cancer,
yeah.
right?
Yeah.
But you need to be checked out. And you know what? I would encourage people today to just pick up the phone. If they haven't had a mammogram, a lot of patients haven't had a mammogram in like 2 years. That they just need to pick up the phone and they can call. They can call multiple facilities in the area. You know, call my office. It's mybreastdoc.com is our website. They look at our contact information. But I would highly encourage patients to do self-breast exam. I would encourage patients to start getting their health care. And, again, reassure patients that most medical facilities are very, very safe to go into now.
Dr. Satyadeer, you think that because of COVID that women just said, you know what, this is the thing I need to worry about now, and just put, you know, getting a breast exam on the back burner?
That's really a good point, and that's probably true. So I'll give you an example. Just in the last few months, there have been several women diagnosed with breast cancer, and the first thing they will tell you is, you know what, I just used COVID as an excuse. I should have really just had this done at the beginning of the year when things opened up. So I would say to you in their wise words is that, you know what, just get it done. It's so easy. It's one afternoon out of your time. It takes less than, 20 minutes, 30 minutes to get it done. So I would encourage people to make time.
All right. And what's your website again, Dr. Satyadeer?
MyBreastDoc.com.
All right. You know, it's always a pleasure, and we love the message you always give to our listeners. And someone listening right now, we hope more than just someone, is going to listen to you and do what you said and possibly find early detection in it.
I appreciate that. Yes. Thank you so much for having me on. You guys are always so wonderful and generous with your time. Thank you.
Hopefully next year we can have you in the studio.
Well, I would love to see you guys. It's been way, way too long.
Yeah.
All right, you guys. Take care of yourselves, all right?
You too.
We'll talk to you.
Bye-bye. All right. That's what it's all about. 86% of people, women, just didn't do it.
And the number 1 in 7 women, that's scary.
That is. So, listen, when we come back, we're going to talk about you've gone out to the store, you had to get gas. We're going to talk about prices that you've noticed yourself have already gone up. 407-919-1067, 877-919-1067. We'll get into that when we get back on Johnny's House. 937 is Johnny's house.
It's going to be a stormy day today with highs around 84. Right now it is 7 to 4.
Conversation we just had off the air, sleeping styles. And I think because of Detroit, now that you're having a baby, you can't sleep on your normal belly down.
No.
Who sleeps belly down?
I do.
That's hard. That's crazy.
It's so comfortable.
I sleep straight up on my belly with my head.
Maybe it's because we got big bellies.
I was about to bring that up. My belly's like, what you doing?
It starts squishing my lungs and stuff.
I can't breathe.
I miss sleeping on my stomach so bad. And I always would either be a side sleeper or a stomach sleeper. Well, but now that I'm strictly sleeping on my side, I hate it. My shoulders hurt. My hips hurt. I just can't
get comfortable. Your hips. Like, I would love to be a back sleeper, but I can't because I snore if I'm on my back, so I have to do my sides.
Yeah.
But if you don't switch sides enough, oh my gosh, it feels like a horse kicked you.
I've never had like pain in my hips like that before, but my God, I wake up every single night.
I'm a side sleeper, but it has to be the side that's open. It can't be the side that's inward towards the middle of the bed.
Yeah.
It has to be outward. And also, like Ray was saying, Missy, I can sleep on my back with a pillow over my eyes up to my nose.
Yeah.
But I'm a snorer, but I don't care.
She sleeps on her back with a pillow over her head.
No problem.
That's crazy. That sounds so uncomfortable.
How's that uncomfortable?
I cover my face with the pillow.
Oh, yeah.
I can't have anything blocking, like, direct air from coming
air, in. You got to place it like right there. So you're getting the air. It's just right there under.
Because I'm a mouth breather.
I get claustrophobic. So like if I'm breathing in like my own breath, I freak out. I don't like that.
You're not really. It's like having a Batman mask on. Mm-hmm. I mean, you got all this covered.
I mean, it cuts right there.
Johnny
your nose.
Sleeps in a Batman mask.
is that
not
what
a
you
pillow.
Got? From what I just said, that's what you got from that.
Yeah, I just pictured you with a Batman mask on sleeping and not actually a pillow.
From what I just said.
You just say it's a pillow so we don't tease you.
He's straight up PJ mask.
Yes, that's what you got from that.
PJ mask.
See, that's why
it's a cartoon.
I know.
That's why you can't sleep at night.
I can't sleep at night because I can't get comfortable because I can't sleep on my stomach.
Man, you want to cuss at me right now, don't you?
No, I just want to sleep.
Oh, and that mic wasn't on. Are you kidding me?
Sleeping on my stomach. That's all. It's just sad.
I'm just surprised you ain't ever slip up on the air.
No, I'm pretty good at it. Surprisingly, with my mouth.
I see. All right, what are some things that, out and about that you've noticed the prices just gone up? I went to the big box store and Ray went to get the meat. I was like, oh my goodness.
Yeah.
Wow.
I feel like it would be easier to say what prices you have noticed haven't gone up.
There isn't any.
Because I think everything has.
I heard that... this year will be the most expensive Thanksgiving dinner in the history of Thanksgiving.
Oh my God.
And usually it only costs like $20.
Yes.
Because that stuff is so cheap.
It's something Brian mentioned a week ago. Everything's
gone up. Yeah. Everything.
You know, before it's like the meat is, and bacon's gone up, but everything else stays the same.
Bacon is ridiculous now.
Yeah.
It's like $9.
Hey, back in my club days, hey, why don't you spend the night? Because tomorrow. I'll make some bacon. Oh, making bacon?
I was actually shocked.
I don't like nobody that much.
I told you guys the other day how we got two boxes of meat shipped to my house because they were doing all these specials, including with like buy one, get two free for bacon. And when Evan said that, I was like, are you joking right now? He's like, no. I was like, bacon is like,
it is like
it's hard to come by right now. Like I can't believe they're just giving it away.
Why didn't you ask us? We'd have bought some.
I have like 7 packs of bacon. Do you guys need any?
No. Just wait. You could flip that probably.
You need to go into the bacon aftermarket. That's what you need to go into.
I don't know what they're talking about, girl. Bring some bacon in here.
I have so much bacon right now.
Good. Oh, look at she over there bragging.
It's not a bad thing.
No, it's not. But now everything is. And I had to fill up my car yesterday. And you know how you just sit back and just, you know, you lock that little thing in the pump and you sit back and just.
I did that yesterday, too.
Oh, my goodness. Yep. Damn.
It's disgusting.
I cry a little when I fill up my car now.
Yeah.
But you get better with gas mileage than mine. Mine and Brian.
Well, she drives 50 miles here and back.
That's 100 miles a day?
Yeah, and I'm a speed racer, so that probably doesn't help. Yeah.
Damn.
I just stopped looking at the prices. Because if it's a necessity, there's nothing I can do about it.
Yeah.
There's really nothing I can do about it. Why am I going to look at the prices and upset myself when I have to get gas?
You can vote the right people in, Ray.
I understand
that. That's what
you
can do about it.
I do.
I stopped at the gas station this morning, and it's so crazy looking around at every pump. People are only pumping like $5, $10 just to like get them where they need to go because it's so expensive.
And they're hoping it goes down tomorrow.
Yeah.
Yep.
Spoiler alert, it ain't.
No, it's not. It's not.
Somebody just said that they work for a big beer company. Get ready for a big increase in the next 3 weeks.
In beer?
That makes sense. I mean, the holidays, people are going to be drinking a lot, and then... Damn. Oh,
the thing is that it's like this storm that's coming this afternoon. We've been talking about it, and it's going to hit this afternoon. Now, we've been telling y'all for a month now, if it's something that you really, really like, stock up on it now. Because closer to when it runs out, it runs out.
I saw fast food prices are going up, like 6%.
What?
That's what they said. There's a few different restaurants all combined, like 6% for your fast food stuff. So
if you like something, it's your favorite, like you can't live without whatever, I got to have some of these in the house, well, you better get some of these now. Whatever some of these is, you need to get those now.
You're the problem, Johnny. You're telling everybody to rush out and
hoard their toilet paper. Wait, have they listened to me? Has there been a run except for toilet paper that one place you went?
Yeah.
No one's listening. No one. And all of a sudden, it's like, man, I went to the store to find. Didn't you say you couldn't find anything, Halloween decorations?
There's nothing.
Nothing.
I literally was trying to do, like, Halloween baskets for, like, a couple of my friends that are coming over. Everything is Christmas. There's no Halloween stuff anywhere.
Usually they have some stuff in the back. Yeah. Ain't no stuff in the
back.
Yeah,
and I was going to order these little Halloween buckets off Amazon. It was $20 for three of them.
Yeah, and then it's going to be like $40 to ship it.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, so there is no in the back.
Maybe I'm doing it wrong. I keep telling everybody that my rum is in stock. Maybe I should tell them there's a shortage.
We got to get it. Yes.
Yeah, there's going to be a shortage. Better run and go buy it now.
We're going to run out. Y'all better get it.
Y'all need to get it now.
Quick.
Get it off the shelf, man. But it is. If it's something that you like, it can be anything. We talked earlier today, if you didn't hear it, listen to the podcast. Wine. So liquor. So everything.
Yeah.
Bottom line is, everybody don't like a lot of things, but if it's something that your favorite, that you enjoy, that you like having around, you might want to get it now. Because there is no more, hey, can you go in the back and check? Ain't nothing in the back. they're on freighter ships out in the ocean,
I just saw a meme that said, tracking your package in 2021, and it had a Google map with a bunch of ships that said your package is here.
On that ship.
Oh, boy.
It ain't through yet, y'all. All right, let's get out of here, y'all. It's 9:44. 9:50 time to get up out of here. Be careful this afternoon. The storm should be coming our way here between now and 4 o'clock. So be careful. They say it could be rough at times. Miss Ray, you got anything going on today?
I have to find Missy some shoes because there might be a shortage of heels.
I haven't seen that one yet.
Like, literally, we went to TJ Maxx. We went to Ross. We went to Target. We went to all these places, and they didn't have, like, any heels for, like, Missy in her size. So I have to go to the mall and try to find something for her.
Good.
And then other than that, I don't think anything really.
Get home and grab the kids and just.
Sure.
Just hang in.
Hunker down.
Hunker down.
No, I'm pretty sure we're going to play t-ball later on.
Okay.
I bet you ain't.
Let me see. Hold on. I got money. Hold on.
What time is later on?
I got $5. So y'all ain't playing no t-ball today.
I say I take them in my backyard around 6 o'clock and we practice.
That don't count. In your backyard?
You got no t-ball today.
So the sky is still, it's still outside.
I know, but I thought you meant sanctioned event t-ball.
Yes.
Like, I can go out in the rain and play t-ball just to get the $5.
Yeah, really.
I'm just saying it's not going to be so dangerous where I can't even go outside.
I don't believe
practice.
You're playing. You ain't practicing today.
I don't believe you're listening to our friend over here on the TV, Jamie.
I feel like it's not even going to rain by my house.
Yeah.
I got $5. I got $5 saying you ain't playing no t-ball today.
No, because you still.
I paid up all my debt. I paid.
Okay, right,
he's actually prepaid his debt.
Yeah, so
Thank you.
Okay for the next 2 weeks, and I don't want to, like, you know, fight that.
Oh, you just know,
like,
you just know you ain't going to be out there playing
no
t-ball today. You ain't out there.
No, I know.
Detroit.
I really need to do laundry today. I've been, like, putting it off every day. I say I'm going to do it, and then I don't, and
I
now
got
it's,
five
like,
bucks
literally overflowing.
Says you ain't going to do the laundry today.
I got $5 says you won't do it,
okay. Deal. Deal.
Whatever.
I literally have no choice because I only fit into leggings right now, and I only have so many pairs of leggings. So, like, I literally don't have a choice anymore. I have to do laundry today. And then that's really it. My bug guy's coming today. We got a new bug guy. I'm not too wild about him, but it is what it is.
I got $5 that says your bug guy don't come today.
Yeah.
I hope he does.
He's gonna blame the weather.
B, what you got going on?
Nothing, just some stuff around here. If you missed the show, of course, you can watch it online, xl1067.com. It's in the Johnny's House live blog. I did put up, I know it's First Responders Day, so I feel kind of bad, just coincidence. I put up a funny video that now has gone national. There is a cop in Jacksonville, a regular citizen, radared him doing 36 in a school zone.
Oh, yeah. and he did not like that either.
The cop stopped, was so mad at him. But the video now has gone pretty viral because now it's on national sites, too. But
bet you $5 it didn't go viral. I'm just kidding. That's something that
already
happened.
Already
I take
has.
That back.
Yeah. Hey, it says here the storm between 11 and 8. So, Ray, maybe we can take the kids out at 8:30 tonight.
It's just like when they give you that time window. They're coming to check your cable between 8 a.m. and 5 p.m. and they don't show up that day.
They have a – it's a Doppler showing the storm coming now.
Yeah, I got kidding. A Doppler for you.
Bet you $5 you don't have a Doppler.
I got another $5 that you don't. Anything else, me?
Also, I found a formula to find out if you have enough Halloween candy. It's a very tricky equation.
Bet you don't have
if you have enough Halloween candy.
I got $5 saying I ain't got enough Halloween candy.
I know you don't have enough. But you can check out. It's Popular Mechanics. They're nerds. They came up with an equation for it. It's all xl1067.com/Brian.
Ryan Seacrest, please take this thing.
I bet you $5
he doesn't.
Doesn't.
Be careful. Be dry this afternoon. And we'll see you tomorrow.